Welcome
Like
to the Cracker
when we
Barrel
haven't,
podcast. Hello and
when there's
welcome
an
to
ad
the
for the podcast. Hello,
welcome to the
Cracker Barrel
welcome
podcast.
To the
Cracker Barrel podcast. I'm eating dinner.
We have a bit of a bare bones setup for on screen here, but believe me, it won't be like that for forever.
Bare bones, more like.
I always find it interesting that the profile picture shown is my Discord profile and not my server profile.
There's definitely just like some shit with that for
It's fine.
With,
that's
like,
that's my normal profile.
The thing
anyways.
That I have grabbed.
Okay.
You know, like there's definitely like a that's just kind of how it is, the thing that I have grabbed. So
perfectly fine with me.
Recap.
There's no recap. Oh, no, you did it wrong. It's exclamation
okay,
mark.
A, you fucked it up, and B, there is a recap.
Or is it in the beginning? Okay.
What? Yeah.
Begin again. We go again. We go again.
How the fuck am I doing this wrong?
I already did it. Doesn't matter.
You already did. Oh. It just says begin again.
Oh, also, I'm going to do a noise test, so...
I like how that's our mic check.
Jake is kind of quiet on Twitch.
I'm gonna turn you guys up and myself down.
You are also quiet.
I mean, that doesn't really matter since we listen to each other through Discord.
So I'm gonna put everything up. I'm gonna put it all the way. Okay, so everyone hush right now. Ready? Clark, mic check. Now, Clark, mic check.
Yes.
Now, Clark, mic check.
Yes.
Now, Clark, mic check.
Yes.
Now,
check, okay. Check.
I'll turn you guys up a little more. Myself up also a little more just to get it up. So I figured out there was something wrong. I applied a filter to our sound, which was like a noise cancellation filter, which like kind of helped a little bit, but not really because all it did was make us quieter.
Yeah.
And it made you guys really quiet. So, like, there are a couple, like, there the sessions as of late, there's been some unfortunate
That's okay.
Ones. It's fine. You know, we'll fix it in post.
We'll fix it in post. It's what Seiji does. Except for, like, the only thing that I have not been able to fix is if you guys have fans rolling in the background. Like, that's the only thing I have not
you
been able
to do.
Do
you hear my fan going off or no?
Not right now, no.
Awesome.
Yeah.
It's usually, like, computer fans, like, if it's like, really close.
Yeah, no, it's probably me, because my computer fan is right underneath my mic, and I need to have my computer in jet mode, or else it won't be able to run OBS and everything. So it kind of needs to be in, you know, jet fan mode. Yeah, no, that's one of the reasons why I'm considering. I might get a PC with my bonus.
Mm-hmm.
Because why not?
I use Ironside. I just didn't want to fucking deal with picking parts and everything. I picked all my parts through Ironside, and it came like maybe, how much? Maybe like
Clark.
2 to 3 weeks later.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's
Clark.
Not too bad. Yes, Sage.
Clark.
So.
Dude, you remember this conversation I had with you about the cat?
Yeah.
Okay. About how Artemis
did they piss on the couch again?
Yeah, I got it out. No, I got it out. It's fine.
That's awesome.
Yeah, he was probably stressed out, but it really stressed me the fuck out because I was up early that morning and I had a full mental breakdown, a full FMB, if you will.
Oh, wait, I still have noise suppression on.
An MOB?
I said a FMB. No, full mental breakdown.
A MOAB? You had a MOAB? Damn.
Wait, can you hear my fan?
No.
Okay, so I'm going to mute the desktop audio and I'm just going to talk. So you turn on the stream audio and tell me if you can hear the fan while I'm talking. La 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 la. I love talking with my fan on. Boo boo doo boo doo hoo boo boo doo boo. Yeah, also do that. Ooh, ba-doo-ba-doo. Oh, I love talking. Oh, the fan is running. Ooh, boy. You know that fan, it's running. Okay. Whatever. That's fine. Yeah, no. Hell yeah, dude. That's awesome. Let's go. No, you aren't.
Yes, I am.
You are not.
Oh, there we go.
You mean on Discord? Are. Oh, yes. I muted you guys for that.
Yeah, which muted me through the podcast. So
what?
Yeah, because I was listening on Twitch and I was like, I could hear you and Jake, and the only voice that was not, like, playing is mine.
Okay. Interesting. All right, good enough. Well, the fellows are gonna be here at some point.
So you know what time it is. You know what time it is when everybody's late.
You do know what time it is, dude. This is so me when it's that time. It's fucking bobble soccer time.
It's bobble o'clock.
It's okay, bobble o'clock. Yeah. Hit the whoa.
Whoa.
My soundboard's broken. I can't do it. Qualifier it is. Flagrant foul. Oh, to be a bird with his tongue out.
Oh, to be a goofy little bird, yeah.
Oh, to be a goofy little guy.
Dude, that's all I have ever been. It's all I ever can be.
I opted for the don't move strategy.
An interesting strategy, Cotton. Let's see how it works out for him.
That's fine. That's fine by me.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, come on, dude. That was bullshit.
I knew you didn't have an ankle, so.
That was some bullshit right there, I tell you what.
Boy shit? Bro, not the boy shit. Hey, yo, what's up, Shoddy?
What's up, Shoddy?
Happy birthday, Jake.
Happy Bertha. Wow, congratulations on conception.
What? Oh, congratulations, Jake.
Oh, yes, I heard someone come in, so I muted. Yes, I've arrived.
You've arrived at New Age.
Man, this is just like Jesus.
I'm old.
New Age plus one.
Yep. My firmware update came out today.
The thing about this is that Jake, you know, last year, Jake said he was what, 24?
Yeah.
Now he's 25? Well, which is it, Jake?
My firmware says it's update 25.1. So.
Damn, you're 25?
I'm old.
Yeah, nah, Jake.
Damn, you're only 2 years older than me?
Yes.
Yeah, Jake is an old fucking man.
Yeah, Jake's not.
I thought you guys were a lot older than me.
What?
Not really. I mean, you were 2 grades below us.
Yeah. I always thought you were at least like 2 years.
Yeah, so that
life.
Makes sense. If I'm 2 years older than you, if I'm 2 grades ahead of you.
Wait,
so
know. What are you? What are you, 22?
Yeah.
I don't know about 22. You.
I'm feeling 22.
Yo.
Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Oh, wait,
fucking
no.
Massive defense. Fucking massive defense. Let's go.
Big happy birthday.
Massive happy birthday to my boy, Jake. Jake, you get a little gift.
For
a little gift from your GM Clark.
Can you know what your gift is?
That's a goal!
Okay. First part of your gift is you get to watch this sick goal again in an instant replay.
Second,
so first it comes in with a penalty kick.
Yeah, second goal. Second little gift you get is a session from me.
Yeah.
Hi, baby.
Yeah. It's not like I get that every Sunday.
Yeah, but this one's extra special, Jake, because it's just for you.
I'm literally dying on the inside.
Fuck! I fucked up. I'm stupid. It's fine.
Ooh, rough. Yeah, are you? You're disliking your current setup? Interesting going big bumper mode. No fucking way. Alright, that's some bullshit right there,
dude.
That's
why I thought it's gonna replay real quick.
That's some bullshit.
Wait, so can somebody please catch me up on everything that I should know?
Yes, we have a very lengthy introduction to this session. Which I will read in full.
The recap is literally begin again.
Part 3.
We're in season 2, baby.
Where is Gus?
Dead.
The fucking intro.
We don't know. We don't know.
What do you mean Gus is dead?
Nick, the fucking intro. It's the fucking... We'll do the intro. Don't worry.
Don't even worry about it, dog. Nice.
Interesting.
Oh, that's funny. My family having dinner is right above me, so I can hear them.
Damn.
They're talking shit about you. Sipping?
Yeah, they're talking mad shit.
Yeah.
Hey, go tell them to stop talking. I'm playing D&D right now.
Be like, hey, bro. Little Vizzy. Oh yeah, no, that was a good attempt, Sage.
Thank you. I do appreciate it.
You're welcome, my guy. I'm always... Look. If there's one thing I'm here to do, it's to help.
That is, debatable.
Oh, woo-hoo. Damn, that's, alright, you know, that's fucked up, but whatever.
Sorry. Wow,
no, are you fucking kidding me? God. Are you fucking, I'm dead, dude, I'm fucking dead.
Bro,
I'm dead as hell.
Man, I'm dead.
Dude, I'm dead as hell.
Okay,
I'm pissed.
Okay.
I'm sorrowful. We're entering
funny.
I'm pogging.
Entering a sorrowful stage.
That was a sorrowful stage indeed, sir. I do apologize for the sorrow.
Yeah, no, pretty sorrowful, dude. When I'm thinking about how that is, I'm like, that's sorrowful.
What the fuck?
Yeah,
it's big head. It's big mode. They're just activating big mode.
Intruder wants to...
No!
What an outstanding fucking ghost there by Clark, if I do say so myself.
No, I saw your ghost.
Yeah, no, and you definitely reacted to
it. You need to,
yeah.
You know what's a good way to evolve your bird cam? You need to get like a bird nest cam. You get like a bird's nest, like a birdhouse with like a camera
a
in the corner
nest?
So you can see like the nest on
I'm
the
sure
inside of the birdhouse.
I'm sure those exist.
No,
yeah,
there are.
Because,
there's videos online. You can watch like...
You can get really good blue jay and American goldfinch.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. You can watch like blue jays and you can watch them like nesting and shit, and then you can see like the babies and shit.
Oh, Bobby,
dude, a squirrel
die.
Hopped onto
the
cam.
Baby.
A squirrel hopped onto the cam, and I used the loudspeaker to shoo it away.
There's a loudspeaker?
there's a one-way talk where I can yell at things through my bird camera.
And you're like, hey,
that's
buddy.
That's classic.
Well, it also has a fucking alarm, but that didn't work.
Damn, I guess it was not very alarming.
It was like it has a siren too, and it just was unfazed by the siren.
Damn, man. Just completely fucking uninterested. Just don't care, didn't ask.
Squirrels are like Chad beings.
Squirrels are nah, dude. Squirrels kick ass.
All they do is eat nuts. Eddie being late, ruining my birthday. Can't believe it.
I guess you better kill him.
Yeah. I'm gonna kill him. I have eyes on the prize.
It was not my best goal swap, but that's alright.
No, but it was a good play.
I was hoping I could get like that angle off, but I was...
Ramp did make it hard.
Yeah, no, the ramp was rough. That's the thing, is I was trying to hold that off, you know, get the point and then hold off the switch goals for next, but... Oh, could it fucking be?
Yeah, it really could. Funny, right?
It's funny, yeah. I would say so.
Funny business.
Yo, shut the fuck up. Oh my god.
I feel like that's really homophobic there, though. Doug, yeah. Come on.
What? You're the one being homophobic.
Oh, wait, no, it's Pride Month. I'm back in the closet. Yeah.
Yeah.
I told people that at work, and they were like, what do you mean? I was like, yeah, don't you know, like, it's fucking, Pride's over. I have to go back and deposit.
Yeah, no, Pride's over. It's no longer trendy, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Which was always my main concern, was trend.
That was always the goal.
Yeah, the goal was always to be trendy.
I never wanted anything more.
Yeah.
Than to be a trendy guy.
God, that was an awful fucking kick by me. It wasn't even a kick.
I claim to have been a trendy guy. I've started wearing belt packs in the trendy way.
Sorry, what?
Okay, do you mean a fanny pack? And you're, what, are you doing it crossbody now?
Yeah.
Nick, did I just fucking hard read your ass?
Nick,
I'll have you know Mitesh has been doing that before.
Ooh, yeah, sorry, bud. I don't know if it's trendy anymore. Right now?
No, but I'm bringing it back.
What do you mean you're bringing it back? It never was.
Bring it back.
Literally, look, if you want to wear a fanny pack, then just fucking accept that you're going to look like a dad from the 90s. Like, that's the whole point.
I don't mind looking like a dad from the 90s. It's fucking dope.
Yeah, so it does. But wearing it crossbody defeats the purpose.
It's reasonable. It's... I thought about... I haven't.
Super
I didn't think
easy
about
to get on and off.
Like a fanny pack, but maybe like more like a merce, maybe.
I mean,
why don't you just say purse?
Yeah, you can just say purse, or even just like a satchel.
A satchel.
No,
yeah.
I refuse.
That sounds
I use
so
a
much
clutch,
better.
Actually,
yeah. That sounds like a fucking. That sounds like a late season fucking King of the Hill thing. Aha! Hank's carrying a purse. I have you know it is not a purse. It is a men's fashion satchel.
Bro, or you could be like, you could recite the entire line from Tangled, the movie Tangled, where she's like, you could tear this tower brick by brick, but without my help, you'll never find your precious satchel. Do I have the whole memory, or the whole Tangled script memorized? Sort of.
It's a cool keyboard.
Yeah, this game is a fucking slow one.
It's okay. I'm about to spice it up.
Oh, thank Christ.
I figured you need something. We need something spicy happening. There's right. Literally it's bone dry out here, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'll take the loss. That means it's something funny.
Let's go! Oh, I should get some water.
Yeah, he's gonna be doing a lot of talking with his intro.
I will gentlemen's. If a fish swam out of the ocean, new legs inside a fucking. Clarky, I'll have you know I'm gentlemaning for you.
Oh, wait, no, I'm back.
Oh,
Sage, I fucking sent my guys. Baby. What?
I was gentlemaning until you got back with water.
Okay, well no, my water, I mean, it's like a 2 second walk, you know, I will gentleman, I'll retreat.
No, I'm
fucked.
I'm kind of like a low-key.
Well, no, I'm retreating. I'm retreating, you can get the ball here.
You just get this guy back in here.
Yeah, no, you just get a guy into the goal and then we, you know, we kill you. Okay, so I'll give you one more gentleman.
Not playing anything. No, I'm doing stuff.
Thank you, Nick.
Yep.
What?
I will buy you
one chest. Alright, no more gentlemen.
What? One what?
I will buy you one chest.
Uncharted?
Yeah.
I don't need to play Uncharted.
Jake, get Uncharted.
No. Jake, this person
Jake,
buy
it's
you
a
Uncharted.
It's Nathan's Drake,
no?
a thief's end.
Up,
Jake,
Clark.
How does he do it? How does he end?
I don't have a PS5.
Oh, are
Jake,
you
why are you denying this man's kindness?
Yeah, Jake, get the fucking game. What do you mean you're taking your headphones off? It's Uncharted. It's like a fucking classic franchise.
Actually, my brother has a PS5, but he's at home. That's all the way in.
No. Oh, look at that ball control there, dude.
Oh, whoa, look at that fucking ball control.
You're not going to see that kind of ball control anywhere outside of the, you know, anywhere west of the Mississippi.
Never.
You, like, just couldn't, you know, not even, not today. You know, maybe never. Back, maybe not back in our, maybe back in our father's day, but.
What?
Oh?
Oh my god, can somebody shoot me already? Fucking shut up.
Okay.
Fucking no. I don't know why it didn't give me like any time to fucking move my dudes, but I.
Yeah, no. Some of them, some of the things don't allow you to. What is that? Oh, I think I whiffed. No, I hit myself. All right, no. We're living. We're living.
Are you live, laugh, loving, Clark?
I'm live, laugh, loving. God damn it, Sage.
I don't know, man. It's just I'm doing all the
you
power
bastard,
ups.
Man.
Is that the Montenegro flag? Why'd you bring that? I don't. We don't have a. I don't have push pins. We'll
Jake,
hang that up.
Jake, it's your birthday. You're finally a man within.
Montenegro.
Within law, yeah. Your 25th birthday. It's a big deal.
Oh well, hang it over there, like over by the door over there.
Yeah, hang it over your gaming setup, Jake.
No, not in the door. We can't open if you hang it there.
Good.
I'm seeing the wall right there. Yes, there. Yeah, I'm saying we don't have pins. We'll have to hang. We'll do it tomorrow or on Tuesday.
Jake has no brother.
No,
I have
because,
no brother. Jake, let him hang up the Montenegro flag.
No, I'm saying that we can't put it there. He's putting in like the worst possible spot.
No, Jake, there is no bad spot to hang a Montenegro flag. That's a big thing. Also, holy shit, Eddie is half an hour late.
Yeah,
all right, we're gonna bully this man.
Yeah, we're gonna bully him. It's my birthday, and he's late.
Birthday. Okay, so birthday. It's your birthday. Birthday. Happy birthday. Birthday.
That works. Yeah, that works.
Happy birthday.
It's our new curtain. The Montenegro flag is our new curtain for our window.
Montenegro. Where's Montenegro again?
Your mom.
Great question.
I think it's a suburb of Canada.
Wait, this way or the other way?
Montenegro.
Should we live stream some bobble while we wait for fuck?
No, we have to.
Gotcha. It's near the
hour.
This is that a good thing?
It's like that means liberty.
This means liberty for Montenegro? Awesome. I'm one with the people. Sorry, where is it? Hello?
He's
coming up now.
Yeah, you said that 5 minutes ago.
Where is it, Nick?
Montenegro? It's in the Balkans.
The Falklands.
Like near Croatia and Serbia.
Look, I'm gonna say it. Hey, hold up. Let me.
Did you ever hear about the time that they invaded the Falkland Islands?
No, hold up. Let me get a fucking thing here. So.
Straight out of Boston. Boston.
Well, that's Boston. No, I'm talking about the Falklands.
Yeah, the Falkland Islands.
I don't know why Falston came out of my head. Sorry.
You know, here you have, give me a sec, let me open up a Word document here, or a paint. Let me get some paint here. So.
Get you a whiteboard.
Here, of course, we have the, can I insert a file into this?
Yes.
You can insert a picture, it's in,
God damn it.
Oh, there he is.
Sorry, I just did some stuff.
On all days, Eddie.
On all days. This day of all days. On Jake's name day.
On Jake's crotch birthday.
Yeah, Jake has been alive for 100 seasons. Think about that.
Uh-huh.
100 seasons.
One Piece.
Yeah.
100.
Through about half the show.
My friend said, I'm as old as, to put in retrospect, I'm as old as Yu-Gi-Oh is.
Damn.
What? That's no, he great. Isn't. He's like an elementary school guy.
What?
I am as old as Frank.
Yeah, you're not young as
dead
Yu-Gi-Oh.
For 1 year exactly is. That's how old I am.
I'm as old
nobody
as.
Cares.
All right.
Nobody asked. Stop so, making Jake's birthday about you. No, I'm just kidding.
Damn. Fucking damn, dude.
All right. I want to make Jake's birthday about Jake.
Yeah, it's about Jake, me, motherfucker.
How do you really feel about the recent tragic death of your player character?
Oh my god. Yeah, shocking. Insight. Great for story. Great but I miss story. Him dearly.
Damn.
Yeah. How about the I daughter?
Got... Yeah.
We're all wondering.
Yeah, we're all...
Vanessa.
So, would you like to do the thing?
Yeah,
speaking of Vanessa, we shall see that in a moment.
Spoiler.
Oh god, you're killing
oh
me.
Oh my Brilliant. Fucking god, Sage. I swear Sorry. To Jesus.
Should I just you shouldn't swear.
Hello and welcome to the Cracker
Clark,
Barrel Pop.
I can't see anything on the stream.
It's just blue, that's the point.
Oh, it's just yeah.
Okay. I was just making sure.
Hello, and welcome to the Cracker Barrel Podcast. Those who were here last session already know this, but for those who missed, some explanation is in order. Last session, the party made their way to the top of Seagrex, a stone's throw away from the Temple of Sin. They found themselves in a lab which was dedicated to the creation of lightning-strengthened monstrosities used to protect the devious Elder Brain. The party engaged with these guards, using the knowledge of their strengths and weaknesses to defeat them. But this victory did not come without a cost. Gus Tolman fell unconscious, and Van Kaiser moved to protect him, but Van fell as well. Their drow host, Zin of House Phylum, moved to help them. Gus was fortunate enough to hang on to life, stabilizing himself but remaining unconscious. Zin, seeing Van in a vulnerable state, placed his sword gently on the back of Van's neck and pierced through him. In the chaos after the battle, Brandwell Jumblejump and Archibald Boreanna called for an extraction and teleported back to the safety of Fenland. Gus was left behind with the drow, his fate unknown. But show must go on. And as all but one player had left that particular stage, that show shall continue in darkness. Let us instead jump to a few seconds before we ended last session. We come into our story at Toreth, the most prestigious arcane university in Ilum. Focus in on the young Vanessa Kaiser. A student at this college. Jake, please describe Vanessa.
Yeah. young,
No, I'm sorry. My roommate is dancing.
Is in he the hitting room, the gritty? So...
Yes, he is. Very indeed. Let's go fucking take a shower. Stop doing that, I swear. Stop. Go fucking away, bro. What the fuck are you doing? No, I'm not telling him what I just saw. Go away. Okay.
That's a beautiful.
Oh my god, my roommate's such a mess. I fucking love him. you see a younger girl, I would say probably in her early teens. She's a half-elf, but her skin is more on the grayer side from her mother's side. She has more, she has short, like a bob, not like a bob cut, but like just shorter
like
white
a wolf
hair.
Cut?
Yeah, she's
maybe.
Got a wolf cut.
Clark, remember the picture I sent you?
She edgy?
Fucking, oh god, that was like
how
several
How edgy would you describe
ago.
Vanessa?
Yeah,
as
how edgy?
Well,
or
as edgy as a Shatterkai half-elf.
Okay, look up wolf cut. I think we're looking at wolf cut.
Can we get it? Can we get it on Twitch?
Situation.
Give me a sec. I'm trying to pull up the art that Jake sent like a fucking year and a half ago.
Minute. That was a minute ago.
Yeah, no, yeah. I'm scrolling
I,
up.
Like,
and...
I, it's hard to find.
Oh, I think I found it.
Half elf Shatterkai are very hard to find.
You just fucking make the picture opaque to make her skin lighter, but that's fine.
Okay, saving image. I'll put it in NPC zone here.
Hey, since I'm seeing Snarb, how old is Snarb? Since Kobold's
on their list. Yeah, okay. Yeah, sure.
Definitely we should be talking about Snarb right now.
Yeah, I just saw him right
Snarb's
there.
Time.
Can we cut to whatever is happening to Snarb? Dude, he must be loving his life right now.
He sees Van's burned body come down the chute.
Ah, yes. More corpses.
I remember
for Snarb.
You. Right. I remember you.
No, he does not. Yeah. Regardless.
So we get a daily update on Snarb every session?
Please.
Just ashen skin, fucking ashen hair, black eyes, long, pointed ears.
Are they ashen?
They ashen also, yeah.
Yeah, but everything is. Everything
is. You gotta use some moisturizer for that.
Yeah.
Alright.
Wearing, I would probably say, is there a uniform? Probably.
Oh, yes. Taurus, the most prestigious arcane university in Ilum? Yes.
Oh, absolutely.
The green checkered skirt and a little bow tie.
Ooh.
She wears the tie. She wears the men's tie instead.
She wears the men's tie.
Oh.
And also the jacket, the blazer. She's professional like that.
Yeah.
But it's got like pins in it because, like, you know, she's edgy.
No, well, the thing is, like, Shatterkai, they're very emotionalist. She doesn't, like, what's the term? It's not wallflower, is it? No.
Yeah.
I mean,
so
wallflower
she's got, like,
is a term.
Says,
yeah,
like,
it is a term.
And, like, protect the animals or something like that. She's, like, an animal advocate. I don't know.
Like
no.
Yeah.
She's a dang communist?
Anyway.
Wait. She's not communist.
So, she makes her way through the halls as she has done a dozen times before, carefully avoiding the gaze of the haughty wizardry students. She tries to hustle past, but instead collides with another student, their thin form crumpling underneath Vanessa's momentum. Vanessa looks at the student beneath her to find none other than Jonathan Laundress, a wizard protege who is different than the others in his class. He was humble, kind, helpful, and currently very out of breath. Ugh. Oh, jeez, didn't see you there.
I'm just going to class.
Yeah, man, totally, same. Can you help me up?
I guess. I'll extend the arm out.
Alright, it's like picking up a apple. Or like a bag of thin sticks. I don't know. He's super light. He
got it.
Stands up, dusts himself off, reaches down, picks up his tomes. You know, you actually got pretty good form. You should try out for the raid ball team, huh?
No way.
I don't do sports.
Oh, come on. It's not that bad. Hey, you took me down pretty easy.
Yeah, because you weren't paying attention.
Well, I'm also not on the raid ball team, but
Yeah, it looks like the wind could take you.
Yeah, I guess that's so.
What race is this individual, would you say?
Would I say? He looks very pale. He has this bleached white hair. You would know him as a Kalashtar.
Okay.
A little guy.
I'll be seeing you around, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. There's a moment of silence between the two of them, as Jonathan's gaze lingers for but a moment too long. And before either of them can react, the moment turns into one of terror. Slowly, Vanessa watches as a sword appears before her. It travels towards... Jesus, what was that fucking noise?
It was Vanessa spitting out her chalky milk.
Yeah. I thought you were going to say the sword cut them in half. So I was just fully ready for that.
Slowly, Vanessa watches as the sword appears before her. It travels to the polished marble floor, taking with it a small piece of Jonathan Laundress's finger.
The blade clatters to the ground, soaking in a small puddle of blood.
Like it kind of appeared out and
apparated.
It apparated out of nowhere, but cutting his finger off. How much?
Not Jonathan Laundress.
How much of his finger? Like, are we missing like the first up to the first knuckle of the finger?
No, or, it's only like a quarter inch, but he's like rolling on the ground. He's like,
it's like a Tarek shot.
Do they have like kind of like a Scott Pilgrim and knives thing going on?
Sure. Why not?
Does it like clatter? Does the sword like clatter to the ground or like?
Yeah, clatter to the ground.
Okay. I'm completely ignoring the dude rolling around with a missing bit of his finger, and go onto my knees and just slowly pick up the sword.
It looks familiar, though it's a little different than the one that you remember. It has a slight design change. It seems that the tip of it hooks to one side. It's a bit sharper. More curved, but you know this sword. It is a sword that you had trained with when you were young, one that you had seen your father fight with, and one in which you understand the circumstance which would lead it to appear before you in this manner.
No, like, emotion is being shown, but a single tear will be going down her face.
Damn.
All right, wait. Stop. Something isn't right. Let's try this again. Is this time, they'll have everyone, I will ask everyone to turn on the sound for the stream. I have a surprise for you all.
Song that you commissioned personally by the Offspring.
Yeah, you don't need to mute. I will fix that on my end so we won't echo. So
that was sick, Clark.
Thank you.
How long did it take you to do
that? Was that? Sick. I did not
like like 4 hours.
Two intro.
It took a long time. Oh god. All right. So
thank you.
Is that I believe that I have regained my bearings. So let's instead jump forward 6 days to follow a more familiar face. Himgai Shahryus barely survived their encounter with the Illithid at the dam. The Goliath decided to return to the Drow city of Garani Sarai, dragging behind him the nearly destroyed Bones Malone. There, they were able to convince Himgai's spouse, the blacksmith Vikala, to allow Himgai to return to the surface to clear up one last debt. That to the Meets Well Done Corporation. Vikala allowed Himgai to teleport to the farming town of Holbeck on the condition that he return once the task was completed. And that is where our story begins. Himgai, you have experienced the sensation of teleportation once before, but it still feels unnatural and leaves you a little queasy. As the arcane flash dims in your eyes, you find yourself on the outskirts of Holbeck. You
You see hundreds of farms before you, stretching out on this plateau far beyond your sight. A small satchel given to you by Abraham Brosden in Dunwich now weighs heavily within your grasp. The sound of creaking wood wheels breaks you as a wagon approaches from the south.
You there! What business do you have apparating in the middle of the road like that?
Oh my god, give me a second. I'm gonna... Ooh. Okay.
Just your teleport, can't afford a steed.
Divine.
Oh. Cannot afford a steed.
Ooh. I'm just looking for my way to Holbeck. Oh, can you point me in the right direction, please?
Are you done doing that?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm gonna hold it down. I'm good.
You're not going to be apparating again anytime soon?
No, I don't even think I can afford to do that in the next, fucking forever.
Alright, well, hop on. I'm heading into town to sell me grain anyways. Get on him back.
Alright, thank you. He's gonna jump on.
Alright, jump on into the back. You see, there's just a... You know, like bushels and bushels of grain and burlap sacks of different seed. Slowly, the cart turns itself and as it starts to head into Holbeck.
Name's Husky. Farmer by trade, but not a part of Holbeck, mind you. Poor bastards.
Poor bastards, eh?
Yeah. You been on many farms?
Probably not. About two or three.
Yeah, well, they sure as shit ain't supposed to look like that.
Can I see the farms around?
Yes.
Do they just look like shit?
As you are traveling, you notice that each plot is separated by these worn down wooden fences, accompanied with an identical farmhouse and livestock stable. Though the land holdings of Holbeck are massive, as you are watching as you're rolling into town, each farm is actually quite small. There are also very few crops, only some small gardens on the side, as it seems that most of this land is dedicated to livestock cultivation.
Seems like there are a lot of livestock, not a lot of food for them.
Yep. There's hell to pay if they can't fill their quotas and whatnot.
Well, exactly hell is what hell entails.
You know, pretty standard things with these sort of situations.
Yeah,
beatings.
Yeah.
Disappear. Ah, who's to say? We've all heard plenty of ghost stories.
I think him guy's just a little uneasy and queasy. He's just gonna keep his head down.
Alright. As you're traveling, Husky breaks into several different anecdotes, which roll on and on and on over several hours as you pass through all of the farm holdings of Holbeck. You finally reach the city proper as the dreadful smell from the farms dissipates into the wind.
Oh.
The town itself looks quite like Ilum, though smaller, much more condensed even. There are several tall buildings, all pristine and new, lacking any signs of wear or history that was evident in the capital of the Garden District. There is also a lot of construction and scaffolding scattered across the town, as it looks like several expansions seem to be happening all at once. As you enter into the town square, the cart stops. Husky looks back to you.
Well, yeah.
I appreciate you for doing this. Thank you.
Ah, of course. I do appreciate that you haven't, thrown up on
yacked
any
all
of...
over your brain.
Yeah, any of me crops. So, good thank you for that.
Here, this is just for, you know, the mileage, I guess. And I just give him, like a piece of gold, I guess.
Hmm. Well, thank you very much, Con Traveler. May Joaquin guide you well.
Thanks, Husky.
I'm going to write some Husky Him Guy fanfic called Cart Stopper.
Wow.
Eddie, 1,000 times disadvantage.
Also, Him Guy has a type, as we know.
1,000 years disadvantage!
Alright, so as you enter into the center of town, your eyes are drawn to a massive silver spire resting within town square, engraved upon which is an image of one Abraham Broston. Scanning this area, you also notice that there only seems to be a single shop in town, simply called the Company Store. The other buildings are inns, taverns, cafes, and several labeled For Meats Well Done Administration Only. The two things that catch your attention is the monumental stadium situated in the south end of town and an older-looking building denoted as the Meats Well Done Corporation headquarters. Yes.
Your fan is real bad right now. I don't know if you had a... Yeah.
I'll try and crank back a little bit. How's this?
It's pretty cranked.
Do you have a noise suppression on?
Yeah, I think so.
Now that's better.
Okay, I think my mic was just like right over my computer because I was like leaning in to read. All right, yeah, no, I'll keep it away. All right, so want me to run that back again real quick? Was it like unhearable?
It's still loud. It's not unhearable. It's just very prominent. Maybe it's fine. No worries.
Okay,
I'll cut it out.
Is it on Discord? Oh my god!
I think it's
wait.
Yeah.
Check. Huh. Weird. Okay.
It seems fine on Twitch.
Okay. Cool.
And now it seems fine on Discord.
Okay. Cool. I'll like rotate my PC a little bit over when in the way. All right. So, I'll just do that little thing once more. Enter into the square of town. You see a massive silver spire engraved upon which is an image of Abraham Broston. You notice that there's only one shop in town, simply known to the named the Company Store. Other buildings are inns, taverns, cafes, and several labeled For Meats Well Done Administration Only. The two buildings which catch your eye immediately are the massive stadium, which is under construction on the south end of town, and the oldest-looking building, and one of the largest, denoted as the Meats Well Done Corporation Headquarters.
Mm-hmm.
So, where would you like to go?
I think I'll go to the shop first.
All right.
I'll just kind of like look at the big tower, kind of look at Mr. Broston. There's no I
Broston.
In his name. Broston.
Broston. Yeah.
Broston. You should spell it B R A U.
No, that would be too clever.
Broston. Because now it just looks like Broston. Anyways, he'll just make his way over, kind of scouting out, like, who's walking around town, maybe.
All right, make me a perception check.
Perceiving. Such a hard job. Well, that doesn't really do me any good. That is a... Wow, my perception is shit. Okay. That's a 6.
Ooh, all right.
I'm a little shaky from my landing. I can't really pick anything up.
Still a little shaky, but you are able to, beyond everything, hear the sound of a clamoring crowd collecting outside.
Oh,
crowd outside of the stadium. Seems that there are several dozen people all clamoring around there, what seems to be a wagon.
Is there anybody near me that I can just be like, hey, what's going on?
Yeah, no, there are a couple who are, like, running over to go and join it. Oh, what do you
can
mean?
Can I, like, Yeah. I just got here. I was kind of wondering, but what's going on?
Oh, you just got here. Well, this is a wonderful surprise. Come, come. It's the Fog Smasher.
What? Okay. I guess I follow.
All right. So as you get closer to the stadium, it is just completely blocked by some farmers, but mostly people who are wearing some levels of finery. And they're all just swarming towards the stadium. Before you can really react, even as you get in sort of close, you are almost immediately surrounded as more start flooding in and flooding in. Your eyes focus on the wagon, which seems to be the beacon for all of this. A figure exits.
Yeah, can I see? Go ahead.
A figure exits from this as the crowd cheers out loudly. Eddie, please describe your character.
Oh, shit. Oh my god, wait.
Eddie, are you muted?
Eddie, you're muted.
Sorry. You see, acrobatically leaping out of the cart here.
Oh god, there's a sports
A flamboyant, oh wait, 2'5" figure. Flipping and sort of crackling through the air with a bit of a pyrotechnic
flare,
exactly. And onto the roof of the cart leaps a kobold dressed in the team colors of, well, would you know the team, would him guy know the team colors, what they represent?
Make me a history check, him guy.
History check I can do. Let's see how good I am.
Yeah, because you're
I should know sports.
You are an Ilum bloke, but it's a relatively new team.
Relatively new team. That is a 17 plus 5.
Okay.
23.
What are you wearing? Is this from your home team or from the new team?
This is from Company Men.
Oh, yeah. So you would recognize this is the uniform of a raid ball player for the Company Men.
Oh, God.
You're all too kind!
Woo!
Now!
Yeah.
I'm gonna, pick up and sign a child.
He's gonna Ricky Bobby.
Yeah, sure, ma'am. I'll sign your baby.
I'm ready to fight. For all back in the Company Men.
Woo! Yeah.
I'm gonna do like a big flip through the air, again.
All right, make me an acrobatics check.
Oh, okay.
Acrobat that shit.
28.
You land that shit so fucking easy.
I'm gonna land on one finger and sit.
All right.
Oh, what time is the game, Clark, today? The first pool game?
Hmm?
What time is the first pool game?
You would note that the Company Men are currently away.
Oh. Then what am I here for?
Me? Hmm?
What am I here for?
You got transferred.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So why would I not be going to the team?
You just got transferred.
Away? Yeah, you just go to where the team is.
You have to do paperwork.
Oh, okay.
And all your fans.
Which is why you are here. I meant to send you that.
Right.
Sorry. Your only current task is to go to the administration building and do paperwork.
All right. How many copies of my contract do you all want?
Oh, me! No, one for me as well! Oh, yes!
All right, I am noting it all down.
I think him guy is going to try to stealthily sneak out of the crowd. He's like, I'm not really a sports guy.
You can't. There's people behind you, and they're pushing you closer.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm back.
Guy.
No. Second.
Yeah. Do you wanna leave this crowd?
Yeah, I think he's basically gonna leave this crowd. He's not a big fan for Jax.
Yeah. You just as you're walking by, you hear people clamoring like, "Oh, this is gonna be our year."
Yeah, it's just like
third year this time, guys. This one for sure. We can get out of the semifinals.
Also, Eddie, what position do you play? I don't think we ever.
Oh, what position do I play? Yeah, I don't know.
Your options as denoted in.
Yeah, I know. I know what my options are.
Yeah, I'll give
Give me a second here. Well,
hey, you wanna tell us the players the options so we can understand how raid ball.
Oh,
works.
You guys don't know how raid ball.
Yeah,
works.
No, you don't know how raid ball works. That's just kind of.
He's the ball,
dasher.
Right?
You're a dasher. Okay, good to know.
You know he's the ball.
All right.
He is the ball.
Yeah, no, you hear it's like, oh, finally we have a decent dasher. All right. So, as you are doing that, him guy, you just sort of wander back off. Is there anywhere in particular you would like to be heading?
Oh, wait, do we have a picture of point of reference of this character? Eddie?
Oh, hang on. I will find you one.
Yeah,
I don't think you caught my character's name, did you?
No, actually. Say that one more time. Who is this guy? Actually, I'm going to go back to the crowd. I'll be like, who is this guy?
Oh, it's the Fog Smasher!
Fog Smasher.
Fog Smasher?
Yeah, he's one of the best dashers out there. Not afraid to get up close and personal, though it technically is against the rules.
Huh.
Oh, cool. That's
he looks like he's
one.
Got the, you know, the skills, the moves.
Oh,
I'm like
you
pushing my way past the crowd. I have a big pair of sunglasses on.
He's got Ray-Bans on. He's got aviators.
They're like pilot.
Do you have like a bomber jacket on too?
No, it's a team. I'm wearing the jersey.
Oh.
Yeah.
No, you got the jersey underneath your bomber jacket with your like picture of yourself on it. Flexing.
Yeah, you turn around and on your back of the jersey or of your jacket is your face with the cool sunglasses that you're wearing.
He walks out with cardboard cutouts of himself in different poses.
Yeah.
Give me one second.
I will just make my way over to the store again. We're like, okay, Fog.
I have it. Okay.
All right, and where are you moving towards?
I'm gonna drop this in player zone here.
Mm-hmm.
Player zone.
I missed. I missed like the last like audio that was sick.
Oh, nice.
What a dude!
Fog Smasher. Wait, are you a kobold soul or whatever?
I'm a kobold draconic whatever monk.
Ascendant dragon.
All right.
Why not both?
So, you're making your way towards the shop there, and as you are walking, you hear something familiar. Not something, actually. Someone. You follow the voice to a small table outside the cafe, find two people discussing a tabletop game. They talk about the game in depth, speaking of longest road, largest army.
Nick, oh God!
Please describe your character.
No.
Well, you see,
I'm a tiefling. And I'm sitting here playing a game.
What game?
Kingdoms of Exanda.
What does your tiefling look like? Yeah, give us a little background on.
Some gray skin, black hair, and green eyes.
Okay.
Wearing leather armor with a trusty sword at his side.
Long hair, short hair, horns, no horns.
There's some little horns and it's kind of shortish hair.
Do we have a picture of reference or no?
No, I don't have one.
Got it.
Use my imagination.
I always like I found this one picture that I thought was perfect when I saw it.
So, Nick, you look over in the middle of the discussing, you see this Goliath looking at you, one you recognize.
Him God!
Oh my God!
As? I get up from my game. Yes!
I'm gonna go run over and give him a big hug.
No way!
As Morphos lives!
Let's go!
Oh my god, I thought I'd never see you again. What are you doing here?
After spending some time at Snow Lock, a sanatorium in the Cold Mountains, I got better. I got over my sickness. And I'm here now, just kind of enjoying myself.
That's fantastic. You look great.
Oh, thank you. Yes, and I've left the dagger behind as well. I'm a man of God now, or nature, or whatever you'd like to call it. But
you like Spinoza?
Spinoza?
He's the one with the Lorax now.
I am with the trees. I am with the trees. What are you doing here, him guy? Where's the rest of the lads?
Who's gonna tell him?
That's a great question that I don't know the full answer to. We should get a drink over that conversation. Let's table that for later. Let's put a pin in it for now.
Well, that sounds
yeah. It's a bit yeah. That's okay. Don't worry about it too much. I'm here on business. Here to, you know, seek out a job. So yeah. That's about it. What are you playing here? Who's this guy? Hi, I'm him guy. I'm gonna put an elbow on ass shoulder and just like give him an up nod to the new character.
Name. Oh, what's your name, sir?
Reginald.
Oh, nice to meet you.
This was going to be Jake's character.
The six.
I also thought it was going to be Jake's character.
Yes. Actually, if you are looking for a job, I am quite the scribe. I could follow you around. Yes.
No.
No. I believe Arshan. I think that's a capital idea.
No, I'm looking for a specific, person, job, business. I'm here out of something, you know. Here, coming in, coming out. So no big news here.
Oh well, for what job are you looking for?
That is classified information.
Oh well, is it a member of? Is it for, you know? Is it for Meats Well Done? Is it for the town of Ulbeck?
A little bit of both, you could say.
Oh then, you simply must follow me. I can bring you right to where you need to be.
Can I trust this guy? Clarky.
There's a roll for that.
Do you want to roll for that, or do you want me to just say yes or no? and then you can believe what you want to believe.
I will roll. I will let the dice decide.
That's a good way to play. Just let the DM say yes or no and just agree with it.
And just agree with the DM.
And just go along.
DM, right, never I will roll.
It. Is that not how you play D&D?
No.
I'm just saying you just ignore the, don't do a roll and just say, hey, is this true? And the DM can just lie to you and you
yeah,
just think
just
it's true.
Yeah, that's how I play D&D. I don't know about you.
Okay, so what do I want? What you want me to roll? Okay.
Be an insight check.
That is a 15.
15? Seems pretty trustworthy. It doesn't look like he's, you know, he by his attire and by his general stature, it looks like he works for this in some capacity. Like, he doesn't look like he's a farmer.
They're for sure the largest employer in the town.
Yeah.
Or employer.
Yeah, I have to make a quick stop over at the store over here real quick. But where should I be able to find you?
Oh, well, I will simply just come with you then.
Sure, all right. Yeah, Ash, you wanna come with, catch up? Tell me about what's going on with your life. How are you? What are your plans?
Sure.
We're making our way over to the store while we walk and talk,
hey,
if
downtown.
You will.
In what direction is the store from here?
The store
in such a direction that they could be making their way.
Yes. Yeah, so currently the store is located. Let me get my crab.
Hey,
crab
yo,
icon.
Harold.
So,
bro,
where's
I
Harold
need
with?
To know where Harold. Can we
so,
get like Harold? Contact?
The store is up here.
Harold one shot.
So the store is up here next to this massive warehouse. You are about here, and
Oh, so you would say you're not actually making your way downtown to go to the store?
Yeah, I would say it would be an uptown.
So that ring is where Eddie's character is, correct?
No. Eddie's character... Son of a bitch, I clicked the wrong thing. Eddie's character is down here.
Yeah, at the
near
stadium.
Near the stadium, which is under construction.
Oh.
You gotta bring a DD if you go to the stadium.
That is... Oh, that's so true. Alright, so you wish to go up towards the store?
Yeah.
All right, you're walking up there. Reginald seems it takes Reginald a moment to catch up with you. He starts. It seems that he had a like a lap desk, like a traveling desk. He has one.
A traveling,
of those.
Yes.
So he's gone and put the backpack on and strapped it. And running past you, on your way over, you notice a couple things. Couple people wandering about. You see some guards, some of the Holbeck guards, like carting away a guy over towards the large red building. Just normal things moving about. A lot of farmers coming in and out of this shop carrying large burlap sacks of grain. You see Husky standing nearby as well. He's offloading.
Oh. I just give him a quick wave and nod and walk. In.
He obliges. Alright. Entering within. The company store is filled with items you would mostly expect for a farming town like this. Mostly farm supplies and tools. On the wall, there is a well-constructed display case which holds a standard-looking axe. The name Mikael is intricately engraved on the front of the case. Behind the counter stands a short, gray-haired man. He's dressed in gray clothing with a white apron. He sighs as you approach. Yes, what might I get for you?
I just came to browse. I wasn't sure if this was a general shop or a... My bad, but I do you mind if I take a look around?
You can go right ahead. You a traveler?
Yeah, you can say that. Yeah, on some sort of business.
Well, certainly haven't seen you before. Name's Roy.
I'll put my hand out to shake his hand.
He shakes it back. His hand is surprisingly not very calloused.
Very nice. Notice he got soft.
Does he moisturize, or does he is he just not a hard worker?
Well, I was about to ask that, but yeah.
If you want to make a perception check.
Yeah, I was just gonna roll. Are you even there? I was gonna call you JJ. I was
back.
Nah, Krantz is with his adoring fans.
Krantz is elsewhere.
Better luck next time. Krantz is elsewhere.
Can I perceive this
Good
man's
job, Mario,
hands?
But Krantz is elsewhere. perceive. Do a perception check.
Perceiving this man's hands. Okay. 19.
All right. Especially being surrounded by so many of the working folk, you know, the salt of the land, and then looking at Roy here, it's clear that he has not done much manual labor. His skin, though wrinkled, is smooth and unburdened. There's a level of even with what he is wearing, which is clearly that of a similar to that of a laborer. None of it is worn. Like, the apron itself is spotless. Yeah, there are no rips or tears.
DM question?
Yes.
So what I have from the last time I talked with Mr. Brosden, that's all I have right now, right? Like, I don't have anybody to go to, as far as I'm aware.
Yeah, I mean, he informed you to go to the administration office to speak with.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I don't know if that got sent with the.
Did not.
Yeah, no.
Okay, so I'm just gonna, wander around. Do I see anything that would be of use to me? Like any potential spell components?
Any blacksmiths?
I mean, if you need
any blacksmiths?
I mean, hell, if you know that if you ever need a trowel, this is the place.
Trowel!
Are they all Meatball Bone branded merch in here?
It's
got a little pizza guy on it.
Kansas elsewhere.
But for the most part, yes, it does seem like Francis all of this is all this is made within Holdback. And okay. You do note it is expensive. Really, really expensive.
Like good old French meats expensive. Well done, really spreading the love.
You said mob front expensive.
You say something there?
Did I say something?
Not you.
I didn't believe that.
I'm speaking to
I
you.
I don't believe so.
Oh, did you not say that out loud?
No, I said that
no.
out loud.
No, Nick.
No.
Being elsewhere,
F, did you say that out loud?
Yeah, I did not. I did not say that out loud.
Okay.
What did Ash say out loud? Or what did you say out loud, Nick?
He said that they're expensive.
No, I said meat's well done, really spreading the love. With the high company town prices. That was just kind of a side note, though.
It's branded,
though. I'm imagining this as, like, one of those, like, hockey team branded stores.
No, it's like the Aquota. It's like, no, never mind. Yeah, it's like a it's like trying to buy a Harvard hoodie in Harvard.
In Harvard, yeah, fair. Alright, I'm just gonna,
It's college prices.
Alright, I don't think I've got the cash for this right now, but I might be back. I'm gonna ask, are you busy today? You're gonna walk around with me, or you're gonna, you know, I'll let you relax. I don't want to bother you too much.
Yeah, I'll look for something to do. Hey, Clark, can I talk to you in the other chat for a second?
Sure.
All right, yeah, just for a second, please.
One moment. All right, someone do an ad read.
Yeah, I will.
What's up?
All right, did we decide what I'm there to do? I kind of am blanking, and I didn't write it down.
Okay, you are there to cover up the fact that you did this. Oh, wait, hold up. Hello. I hope the ad read was good. I also realized that since the thing goes through my headphones, no one heard the ad read. So,
good.
So, either way,
that's my best one yet.
You know, you're just sitting there. It's the expensive farm store. It's like going to Ace Hardware.
So you get your bolts.
So I said to him, guy. I mean, I'm just enjoying the town. I have nothing to do tonight. I'd like to hear why you're here, especially.
Yeah, I gotta make my way, I think, to the administration out here. Why don't you say we grab a drink later tonight? Catch up on all the... I want to hear about your mission towards nature and stuff and how that's going. And I'll update you on all the good stuff, but... I should make my way
good
over there.
Good stuff, he says.
Yes, I would like to find a very good, spread the good word on stones and nature.
Oh, that's fantastic. You should meet a guy named Gus. Met him, yeah.
Damn.
Anyways, I will, I'm gonna head out. You two, chillax.
Oh, yes, so but I must guide you. I can guide you to what it is that you need to be.
Oh, I think, you know, I'm pretty good at making my way around.
Oh, very well then, you, when he points to ask, you owe me a rematch. That longest road was, you know, garbage, and you know it. Come on, come now.
Give him hell, yes. Ass.
To Exonda, board game.
Exonda, the board game, yes.
All right, and you walk out. So you want to go to the admin, him guy?
Yeah.
Okay, so... it's pretty clear which one is the building that you should be going to, because it is. Yeah.
Carlos Bakery in Hoboken, New Jersey.
So. Yeah, so, you make your way towards the headquarters, and as you enter within, you are stopped by a secretary up front. You look over to the side of you and you see a kobold
that you had seen before, similarly walking towards the admin.
There's like a gaggle of people following me. I have a like a bunch of paperwork clutched in my
sir, Mr. Firebreaker, can you sign my action figure of you?
Snot dripping down the nose.
Is that your character?
No, it's not.
Because that would have been it's sick.
A child.
A small child. No. No, I just wanted to do a voice. I was in the moment.
Okay.
In the mood for a voice.
What am I doing here? Am I here to deliver my paperwork?
You were here to do your paperwork, yes.
Yeah.
I'm gonna sort of. Hey, look over there!
Whoa, where is it?
I'm gonna cast Thaumaturgy.
Alright.
I'm gonna make it look like a bunch of, you know, fireworks and meats well done, our company men team colors going off outside.
Whoa!
Alright, let's get inside.
I'm gonna use that as a distraction to get to the counter first.
Alright.
I'm gonna shut the door behind myself.
You shut the door, everyone turns around, you can hear people say,
how did he do that? Where did he go? Guys, we gotta find him, I need a copy of that contract!
He didn't sign my action figure.
The kids, says Kritz.
Alright.
Kritz, by the way, is canonically 13 years old.
How old do kobolds live? Yeah. 20 like years? 80, how old are you? 19 years, 364 days.
364 days and 5 hours.
Damn. So, you approach the desk, you're stopped by a secretary. Greetings to you, and thank you for visiting the Meats Well Done Holbeck headquarters. Do you have an appointment?
Yes, I think so.
May I see the appointment paperwork?
I was never issued it. I was just.
You were given a satchel by.
Was I?
That satchel is long in the Underdark by now.
No, I would have it. Like, it would be. I have probably
what,
put it in
what
my.
What was the time frame? How long were we down there?
A small satchel given to you by Abraham Broston in Dunwich now weighs heavily within your grasp.
Yeah. All right. I pull out the satchel and I kind of tussle through it. Do I see the paperwork?
You do. You see a couple pieces of paper that have several stamps on them.
Here. Sorry. It's been a minute.
Oh, interesting. From Mr. Broston himself. Well, yes, I can bring you right into Mr. Ferris soon, and I think I recognize you! Pointing towards Krantz.
You know, I'm just happy to be here. You know, represented Holbeck.
Oh, well, I'm happy to have you here, our newest company man. I'm very excited to see you out on the pitch.
Certainly puffed up. Is, you know how, like, those lizards do that, like, frilly thing?
Yeah.
With their necks?
Are you flexing your frill right now?
That? Yeah.
I think him guys is like,
he's doing like a Zoid bird.
He's perhaps the first canonically heterosexual character to appear in this.
Wait, what?
So.
Van was heterosexual, 100%.
Van's dick didn't work.
Yeah.
All fair.
Van was asexual without choice.
It don't work now, I'll tell you that.
Oh, no, definitely not. After like 6
losing
days.
That much blood, it's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Van was demi, and then he became ace as a matter of circumstance.
They say, as a matter of being
they say you get a boner when you die, and it was the last time and the first in many years that.
I swear that when you die, you shit yourself. Oh my god, he did.
All right. Back in. Do you have paperwork as well, Mr. Krantz?
Yeah, I'll ruffle around in my pack and pull it out. My Dungeoneer's pack, I believe, is the pack that I have. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wonderful. All of your paperwork is also in order. Also seeing Mr. Ferris. Well, please, follow me. You are led to another desk with another secretary, who then escorts you to another desk with with another secretary. This happens 3 more times, each of which checking your paperwork, Hem Guy, and each of them complimenting you, Krantz. Finally, you reach your destination. The secretary opens the door, which slowly and silently opens up into this massive office. Several bookcases and lounging areas strewn across the room. At least you figure that there are these things underneath the piles and piles of papers. Papers slowly crescendo from the front door to the end, climaxing on the desk. Sitting behind approximately 3 trees worth of paper is a very nervous elf. He's wearing a nice suit, which has clearly been worn for several days based on both the wrinkles and the smell. His hair is long and matted down. Beads of sweat slide down his greasy face before splashing down onto the desk. He does a quadruple take at the party before he truly notices you. A small placard on his desk denotes him as Ferris, head of operations. Let me get the Ferris image Bueller? Here. Hmm?
So, damn, Ferris Bueller? He's gotten old.
Yes, definitely. Moment.
This feels like a interview situation where one person is getting there to like work really hard and the other person's a nepo baby.
Yes. Well, I'm a recruited athlete. They fudged my SAT scores. I have 7 intelligence.
We all know that SAT scores are not used for fucking college entrance anymore.
Well, they not after they you all got in, caught
you,
fudging
you
them.
Got in with a scholarship. That's you got into college with a scholarship.
An athletic scholarship, yeah.
Yeah.
Ferris looks
I
up.
I went to Ilum State.
Ilum State University. You went to the college I went to. Even though...
I tell people I did.
You went to Ilum Community College.
Ferris looks up to both of you. Yes? As you open your mouth, your statement is interrupted as the doors behind you crash open violently. 2 guards enter, holding a captive between them, one that you had seen before. Jake, please describe your character.
What?
You see a rather tall-looking human with a lean build and curly brown hair that's parted down the front. He's wearing rather nice-looking clothes, some formal wear, a white shirt, black tie, with a long turncoat. Long jacket.
Do you have a short skirt?
Nah.
And I'm not interested.
Damn.
On his right hand, he wears a black glove, but on both fingers, he wears 2 rings on each finger, on one of each finger, on his, like, index fingers. His eyes are I would say probably like a light blue. And the first thing you say is, well, obviously, if you're going to be pulling me away just because I pulled a dagger out to show an invention I've created, then you obviously don't know what you're talking about.
Silence! Mr. Ferris, we found this one trying to sell unlicensed products in the town square.
Just because I then gave the weapon to a small child and told him to flick it at me to cast a spell to show off my abilities, I'm sorry.
Ferris looks at the guard. You interrupted my meeting for that. Do you know what the penalty for that is?
Yes, but guard.
What is your name?
Farley, First Lieutenant.
The elf shuffles around his desk for a moment until he finds a particular parchment. First Lieutenant Farley, get out of my fucking office, or your kids will be spending their time in the town square begging for scraps.
Well, of course, but what of the criminal? What the fuck am I supposed to do with it? You're the guard. Give him a beating and be done with it.
Well, that's rather unneeded. I could have just stopped if you said no.
Farley stands there for a moment and then looks to the other guards, looking back towards the elf.
Divine's not in here! You're worthless. You are worthless! Just leave him here and get the fuck out of my sight.
guards shuffle out in silence, leaving this captive in the room with you.
Well, thank you.
Shut the fuck up. All right. He sits down into his chair, points very lazily at you, him guy. May I see your appointment papers?
Yeah, here.
He looks over the packet of papers, his eyes glazing over as he quickly reads through the text. Ugh, I see. You're the mercenary, Mr. Broston found. And he turns over the small calendar on his desk. Oh, look at that. Right on time. Are the others with you? I figure not him. Not this guy, eh? Pointing towards
me?
Krantz.
Oh, thank you.
Shut the fuck up. Krantz, please. The Fog Smasher himself.
Oh, I'm just hoping I can do the company man as proud as I did the Foggy Bottoms.
I'm certainly sure you will.
Wait. Stop. Did you say your name is Fog Smasher?
That's what they call me. It's not my name. My name is Krantz. Nice to meet you.
Oh,
I'm reach your hand out. You think it's to shake your hand, but you are tied up, and I just sign your forehead.
Am I tied up, or no, was I just being dragged?
No, you're just being dragged, as far as I know.
Yeah, you were being dragged.
Yeah, he
you think
brushes
it's to shake your hand.
He leans out with his right hand, his gloved hand.
Krantz just kind of reaches past her. He didn't even think that it was a handshake. He just signs your forehead. Because Krantz, the Fog Smasher.
I proceed
a long
to
time
smell the material and I'll lick it.
It's on your forehead.
No, I'm like, I wipe the material with my finger.
Oh.
I'm wiping the material. Yeah, was it ink?
It's ink.
Hey, criminal. I wouldn't do that if I were you. That signature's the only thing giving you any worth right now.
It's just some ink.
Yeah.
I'm talking about this. How
ink
is this
signed
value?
By Krantz the Fog Smasher. You're a piece of merchandise now.
How much can I sell myself for?
Depends on what you're willing to do, huh?
Good one, Krantz.
Good one, Krantz.
He shuffles through his papers and he's like, a couple silvers, maybe. Anyways.
It's not really much, but...
All right, well, I'll deal with you two, pointing to Krantz and Edwin. We'll deal with you two in a little bit. You, pointing out to him, guy. All right. Are you alone? Did you not bring anyone with you?
There's one other person who may. Let's just say it's just me for now. Yeah.
All right. Well, more gold for you then. Well, anyways, everything you are all about to hear right now is confidential information. At least it was a few weeks ago. Mercenaries tend to have trouble keeping secrets. And you, him guy, I hope you are the exception to that.
Yeah.
Several months ago. He does not take much stock in that. He seems pretty unhappy with that reaction.
Pretty nonplussed.
Yeah.
I didn't want to interrupt you too much.
If this is confidential information.
Bro, literally shut the fuck up. Nobody asked you.
Yeah, shut the fuck up. Open your fucking ears. You go sit on that fucking couch. You sit there. You shut the fuck up.
I'm gonna go through my bag and pull out my robotic bird.
Do they like ferrets?
Robotic bird.
Oh, can that turn into a chair?
Archimedes, do you know what they're talking about? I don't understand.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to my bird. My mechanical bird.
What's the name of your bird?
Archimedes.
Right.
Divines. Unless you're pulling a device out of that fucking bag that can go fuck yourself, then shut the fuck up. Listen.
I proceed to pull a long broom out. Like this.
Oh.
Just don't get anything on the carpet.
my god, this is great. Alright, I'm so sorry.
Several months ago.
Yes.
Johann Yunling, a brilliant botanist and scientist, was found dead in his office. His skin was covered in green veins, symptoms of one poisoned with a deadly substance known only as Garrote. An internal investigation was held by the Holbeck Guard, and no suspects were found. Mr. Brosten was not pleased with this investigation and reignited the search, this time bringing in our contract workers, thus the mercs, and thus the rumors. Hearing this, Himguy, you are reminded in your mind of your conversation with Brosten, where he stated that he didn't know who you could trust within the organization. That he did not trust this investigation.
Yeah.
Ferris continues. The information leaks aside, one of our enforcers managed to track down the killer, one Langdon Talish. He was tracked to a old fortress nearby, where he has burrowed in with his own mercenaries to protect him. Your task is to simply... Ferris reaches down towards his desk and closes a folder. Close the case. You understand?
Understood. Yeah.
You got a case report?
Excuse me? Yeah, do you,
I have a, I have here...
Like a formal contract? Is this like a formal contract? How does this work?
You shut the fuck up! Now, I see here... We have a small stipend, which should be used to purchase gear for your journey. I do recommend you actually spend it while you are here, both to stimulate the local economy, and because the last thing we need is to be giving more gold to Langdon Talish. See Roy at the company store. Tell him you want to see the wares in the back.
What do you mean by giving more gold to Langston?
Well, if you take this stipend here, and he slides a small chest towards you on his desk, if you don't spend any of this money, and you go out there, and you die, that little shit is just gonna have your gold.
Yeah,
so,
understood.
Stimulate the local economy, why don't you?
Yeah, will do.
Francis, with his seven intelligence, is still trying to piece together the joke here.
I'm going to put the chest. This is going to blow your mind, actually. I'm going to take the chest. I'm going to open my bag of, like, Clark, I think you know what bag I'm talking about, the bag of that holds everything.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to open it.
The bag that could hold everything.
I don't know what the fuck it's called. And I'm just going to slide the whole chest into the bag. And...
Or it's not like a massive chest. It's like...
No, I know. Yeah, I know, but I figure it's like big enough to be like, will it fit in the bag? It's gonna make it like stick out weird and shit like that. It's just gonna like plump, fall in.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, very well. I am available and able to answer any questions you might have.
I slowly put a finger up.
I'll get to you in a second. I'm here to answer any questions you may have, but after I deal with the others.
Yeah, understood. Can I just glance through that case file?
Yes. And he goes and he slides file across to you.
All right, I'll pick it up and find another seat.
Yeah.
Or, no, go ahead.
Your contact and guide is one of our best enforcers, a man named Booker, who should be staying at the Hero's Rest. He will have specific information about the target, mostly what's in that dossier there, but a little extra, you know. Intuition, stuff of the business, you know the type. If you have any further questions about the job at hand, or, shuffles through some more papers, or the meat's well done family of products, feel free to ask me after I deal with the others.
Yeah, we'll do.
Mr. Krantz! It's good to finally meet you in person.
May I see that paperwork you're carrying?
Yeah, I'll hand it over.
All right, perfect. I will deal with all of this. This town has been in such a rage since the news broke that you were coming to play for the company, man.
You know, I just, like I said, I just want to do the team proud. It's got such a storied legacy. You know, just a real, all glory go to God, Tiamat. And I'm just, you know, really, really looking forward to playing here for a long time, hopefully.
Wow, that, yeah, I'm very, very excited to see you out there, you know, smashing heads and whatnot. So, as you could probably see, as you were coming in, and I do apologize, but it does seem that our stadium is currently under construction. You know, the farmers aren't exactly working as fast as we had expected them to. But for the time being, and since the team is a little away right now, you know, taking the architects on up in the Elven Quarter, you are free to do whatever you please. Might be a good idea, you know, make some appearances, gain some fame while you wait for our first home game.
What's this place, the Heroes Rest, you were talking about?
Oh, it's an inn, tavern, everything you could really need.
Maybe I'll go there and make a public appearance, sign some stuff.
Good idea. Yeah, gain some fame while you're out there. We only ask...
Do you have any, like, prototype products I can hawk?
Oh, not really. You can talk about the, he goes and he flips through the, leave it to the ribeye. Yeah, that's the one we're trying to push right now.
Sounds good. Oh, watch this. I'm going to thaumaturgy up. Oh, well, I'm going to pull from my pack because I will just have some stuff. Some steak.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to wave my hand around, very dramatic. I'm going to punch the steak. On contact, my little draconic fist ignites immediately, giving a perfect reverse sear to this cut of beef.
All right, please make me a... I guess this would be a wisdom check.
Would it be, like, survival?
I mean, I think wisdom makes sense. Like, it's your casting. It's okay. your modifier as a monk, and also...
Natural 20!
It is immaculate. The smell hits all of your noses, and, you know, it's near level of, you know, floating in the air, drawn by your nose, floating towards it. Wow, that is really something. Yeah, if you need any extra meat, do just let us know. We'll get some of our master butchers to get you exactly what you need.
Will do. I'll cut it up into slices for, like, a large slice for Ferris, a medium-sized slice for him guy, and, like, a tiny sliver for Edwin.
Okay. Ferris takes it, he sets it down on his desk.
This is barely a cubic inch.
I think it's more than it would be like probably about 4 cubic inches, the piece I gave you.
Not 4 cubic inches. You want some? No, you can't eat anything.
Huh.
I'm like sort of back away from this situation here.
Right. Yeah, well, Krantz, we only ask that you don't seriously injure yourself or, you know, get traded to another team.
Hey, that's not my choice.
Yeah, it certainly isn't. But, don't worry, you're going to be great. Get some fame going, you know, whatever you got to do.
Can I insight check that? Can I insight check that?
Goodwill in the community.
Insight check what?
I want to see if Edwin gets the joke.
Okay. I guess that would be more of a charisma check.
Oh, really?
I mean, yeah, you're attempting
to, like, laugh.
Yeah, you're like attempting to pick up like a social cue. I would say that's charisma.
Okay, just a charisma roll. Well, yeah. I rolled a 17.
All right, yeah, you get the joke.
He slaps his knee and starts laughing.
Oh, fine. All right, now for the troublemaker. Do you know what the penalty is for selling unlicensed merchandise within Holbeck?
Well, no, that's the whole point.
Do you know what the penalty is? We're selling unlicensed merchandise within Holbeck.
Can I roll an intelligence check to see if I knew that or not?
Sure.
How is a 18 sound?
You would know that that sort of thing would require some level of corporal punishment. Not death, but some level of physical harming. I was not kidding with the guards when I said it was a beating.
Look, I'll be honest with you. I kind of planned this to try to get myself in this office. I wanted to talk to someone like yourself in a position of authority, I would say. Obviously, I can see that with you talking to those guards like that. I'm just simply trying to get my name known that I could potentially, we could work together. Come on.
You Sandra? Must have heard of me. Yeah, Sandra, could you get the guards just on my door? Thank you.
Wait.
No, go on.
I simply was trying to get my name to you guys, the top hats and all that. I just want, because I would like to like work with you potentially to sell goods. I'm an inventor after all. Come on, you've must have heard of me, or at least my family, of course. Come
Which
on.
Is?
Stormmind, Edwin Stormmind is the name.
Edwin.
He walks back over to his desk for what seems to be the millionth time. He shuffles back through some papers. Oh, Stormmind. Yeah. Yeah, no, that's a DNP.
What does that mean?
Do not purchase. You make shoddy crafts.
Whoa, shoddy is a little too far, I would say.
I would say not too far enough.
No, I would say
gone too far enough. Your
product testing is, I believe, the term that you would use.
Look, kid. I'm not really in any sort of desire to give you any sort of stock within purchasing within our company, given that you were just arrested in our town square. So, here's what I'm going to tell you. Maybe you do a little proving, put on a little show that is sanctioned, or, you know, do something that is acceptable, allowed, to prove that you and your family are somewhat trustworthy, and then maybe we can talk. But until then, the beating.
Oh, come on. We don't have to do the beating.
We do.
Come
on. We do have to do the beating. But if you cooperate, we can do this without any serious bodily injury. So, are you going to cooperate?
He stands up, cracks his knuckles, like he does some firm stretching. He puts his bag down. He puts his bird on top of the bag. Okay, I'm ready.
All right. Ferris steps back.
I have a beaming smile.
Ferris steps back. He rolls up his sleeves. All right. I'm going to punch you once. You're going to take it. And then we're going to fill out the appropriate beating administration forms. Understood?
That's perfectly fine. Just do anything above the belt, of course.
Yeah, certainly. All right, so you take...
That's a long hesitation.
9 points of bludgeoning damage.
Damn. You're not even going to try and roll and hit?
Are you taking Paris the punch?
Hands. Yeah, I'm taking it.
Yeah, if you're not taking the punch.
Nine damage, slip counter
the punch?
Yeah, 9 damage.
Can I attempt to try and roll with the punch?
I mean,
can I attempt that?
Would you like to?
Like, try and roll with it? So I do less damage? If you get what I mean?
You know, I get what you mean. Sure, make me a dexterity check.
Would be saving throw or check?
A 4.
Yeah, you start way too fucking early. And he goes, and he still punches you, but it's clear that you tried to, like, dodge out of the way of this. You see what you did right there? I saw that.
I know you saw that. I did a really poor job of
doing it. All right, okay. Well.
On the other cheek, I guess. Come on, just
do it. He shakes his hands out. All right. So you do take the 9 damage. He still clocked you in the chin.
Yeah.
All right. You gonna sit still this time?
So I'll put my hands behind my back.
Okay, that doesn't stop you from, you know, trying to duck out of the way. You know that, right?
Just do it.
You want me to hold him in place, Chief?
Huh. You know, Krantz, it would be an honor.
I'm gonna cast Entangle.
Wow.
Alright.
That's fascinating.
So out from the floor comes these twisting vines which wind up your body immediately versus like, oh, the carpet! Oh, the carpet.
I can fix that for you, you know.
Sandra, after this, Sandra, get the carpet guy on. I'll talk to him tomorrow. All right, sit still. Ooh, another 9 damage.
Okay.
You're cracked in the face again.
Yep, 18 damage.
All right, good. Hold your nose up. Don't bleed on the carpet. It's fucked as much as it does already. Well, you took that punch well, at least. All right, please sign here. Initial here, and
we'll end the entangle. You see his divine stairway leading a somewhat damaged rogue.
By the guards.
Well, so we know the punishment was properly distributed. And it also keeps the guards from killing people they're just supposed to beat.
Ah, I see. Funny. Nice.
Yeah, no, I'm not kidding.
Oh. He does a very wide and long signature in immaculate cursive.
All right. Good. Well, you two, he points over to Krantz and him guy, you can stay as long as you want. You, get the fuck out of my office.
Pick up my bag, my bird. Bird's under the arm. Okay. Walk straight out.
Yeah, bye. Don't come back. Is there anything else I can do for either of you two?
Nothing that I can think of. I guess I'll just go to that tavern there.
Yeah. Well, what? Okay, you're going to make your appearance?
I don't know. Maybe we should build hype a little bit first. I'll go there in like an hour. We can announce it. Is there some way to announce it?
I mean, I can make a... I don't know. I'll just pass the word around.
I mean, I can make my voice loud and booming through magic.
Yeah. Cool. All right. Thank you, Mr. Ferris. I'll be on my way. I'll be back if I need you.
Very well. I wish you the best of luck with your task.
A task indeed.
Yes, indeed.
All right. Thanks again.
Dark Souls dialogue.
A task. Yes.
Yes.
All very right, well. Peace. All right.
Great. I'll just follow.
All right.
I'm going to keep turning around. And
how do I avoid this crowd?
Seeing him.
How do I make sure they're all in one place?
How
do I make sure the crowd are all in one place so I can, like, get around in this part?
Why don't you just, like,
control the crowds.
Hide behind me? And I'm, like, I don't want to say it, but I think, you know, I could provide some cover if you're trying to get somewhere without a lot of people noticing. Or you want to jump in the bag?
Back on. The bag? It's a great idea. I'll hop in the bag.
Just hold my hand. Oh, no.
All right. You find yourself in a dark space. You cannot breathe.
Wait, hold on. Okay,
oh.
Wait.
I'm gonna the flap. Start waving around violently.
I'll put my hand in there for him to grab onto.
It's not a grab onto. You need to choose what comes out of this bag.
All right, I choose Krantz. I'm pulling Krantz out by his like collar.
All right.
Like I don't go all the way.
What's
in, dumbass.
You mean like poke my head out?
Yeah, just hold on to the corners and fucking, yeah, you're good.
Okay, I'll do that. I'll try to do that.
All right, it's easy enough. It's pretty, you know, you're just kind of sitting in a bag.
Yeah.
Krantz has become a passenger princess.
It's true.
From the looks of it, it looks like a lot of the crowd has sort of dispersed and sort of wandered about. You know, like, it was exciting that you got there, and, like, people will be excited when they see you, but there isn't, like, currently a
climb out of the bag.
Yeah, all right, I'll let you out of, like, the door. You're like, all right, there you go.
All right.
I'm gonna pick him up. Wait, I'm gonna set the scene. I'm picking you up under your arms like a child and setting you down gently. And I'm dusting you off a little bit. Like, there you go, bud.
Aw, thanks.
Yeah. Alright. Head in, I guess? Yeah.
You notice while you're walking that Prince walks very quickly.
Yes.
Almost as if his base walking speed were 50 feet.
Wow, he walks so fast.
Alright, so as you exit out of the headquarters, you, look around again. The crowds have sort of dispersed. Night is it's nearly night. The sun is just starting to set. You see him guy. You notice ass sort of hovering nearby near one of the other cafes, just kind of relaxing.
Mm-hmm.
What would you like to be doing right now, Edwin?
Oh, I was standing next to the. I was leaning on the wall right outside the door, waiting for him guy.
Oh.
You there, big man.
Hey, what? Hey,
you dumbass. Of large stature, I feel like would be a perfect individual to help me with my experiment I have.
I am on a working journey to not make promises that I can't keep, so I'm going to have to decline your offer.
So that's a no.
Yeah.
Well, that's...
I've heard that if you say no, it kind of like makes you uncomfortable, but it's better than saying yes and drawing out the uncomfortableness. You know what I'm saying?
Well, it wouldn't be that hard. Please. I just need you to like hit me with some magic that I've been working on. And some other
Jizargo.
I'm not really trying to get you A, beaten, B, killed, or C, myself in trouble.
We don't have to do it in town. We can just do it outside of town where no one's really going to be paying attention. I need more research.
Let's go to the bar.
Can we? Yeah, let's put a pin in it. If you want to come in. Come on. We'll talk about this. Put a pin in it. Yeah, let's go. All right, you guys go fraternize. I have to go make conversation. I'm gonna look for the individual. I'm assuming like he's got like a small little like photograph in my little fucking case file who I'm supposed to be talking to.
You're looking for Booker?
Yeah.
Fucking
T Booker.
There isn't anything on Booker in the dossier. The dossier is 100% like there is a archaic art autopsy report.
Oh, okay.
That the documentation there is almost all medical.
Okay.
Yeah, like the additional information seems to be with Booker.
Okay, so I'm gonna look for Booker, or I'll ask. You know.
All right, so you want to go to the Hero's Rest?
Yeah, that's where I thought we were going.
Okay. Ask, would you like to join them?
I thought we were.
Sure. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll just like shout to him. I'll be like, "Hey, Ask."
I move over.
Hey, I gotta make my way over to the Heroes Inn. You wanna come with for a bit? Might be able to grab a drink there. But I gotta talk to someone real quick.
Sure.
Cool. Yeah. Right. So
cool.
The halls of the Heroes Rest are a far cry from your previous impressions of Holbeck, given the farms. Gone is the poor farming community that you had once inhabited. Surrounding you are masterfully formed marble columns running up to the ceilings. Alabaster statues of a strong-jawed mustachio man line the entrance.
Look at this place.
Yeah, I don't call it hero for nothing.
Guess not.
You find yourself.
Right, I'm gonna go inside. Ahead. I'm gonna go inside ahead of everybody.
Okay, or you are inside. You're in a bit of a foyer.
Oh, okay.
Moving forward, you note that there are some. It looks like there are rooms off to the side, and just sort of several different like windings, almost into different wings of the building. This place is like truly massive. You do note that as you walk through, this noise echoes from across the hall. Following it near its source, you see that there are several rugged-looking people enjoying a bar off to the side. Many of the people who are there are wearing some semblance of armor, though much of it is dirty and falling apart.
See those guys over there? I got an invention that I've been working on back home. Could easily fix that and make it at least 0.5% stronger.
That's not a lot.
It is.
And that's not a risk. No, it really isn't.
0.5, theoretically, is pretty strong. Something that is not.
How sure would you say you are of that in percentage?
Oh, 100%. I believe in everything I say.
Okay. You didn't say
believe
10
in everything
billion
I make.
Percent.
Yeah, you didn't. The fact that you didn't say 10 billion throws me off a little bit. You know,
10 billion percent. There.
Okay. Well, you said it now because we asked you to say it. So
get excited,
you know,
guys!
Kind of
come on. For this new
no,
invention
no
I
excitement.
Made.
I think Kim guy is tired and wants to go find Booker, so he's just gonna look around for.
Prince is gonna go hop up
to.
On a table.
You there, right,
you
man.
Do that.
What's your name?
Yes.
I never caught it. Edwin Stormind.
Ask Morthos. Nice to meet you.
You seem like a cultured individual.
Oh, no.
Tell me of your travels.
Oh, I've been here and there.
And everywhere.
From Ilum. Or, well, from Daltry, but I grew up or spent a lot of time around Ilum and been traveling since. Spent a little time in the mountains of Snowlock. Pleasant place.
That is on my list. Is there actually snow there, like it says in the name?
Yes.
My god.
Yes.
That's amazing.
It is pretty
cool.
I just
recently started traveling. I'm very excited.
Alright, I'm looking for Booker.
You stick with the Locross Crusaders, then you'll get much travels.
What are they?
The little merry band here, but I guess this big fella right here is the last one.
Well, that's not really a band then. It's a solo, wouldn't you say?
Well, I mean, right now we have a company of 4 people.
Locross Crusader.
The Locross Crusader.
Well, there is a plural version of that, but the whereabouts are currently difficult to. Let's not talk about it. I'm gonna go.
You're gonna put a
else.
Pin in it?
Huh? Let's put a pin in it. Yeah. Can you shut the fuck up? You're not very good at that.
I'm sorry.
No, you're good. Sorry. I'm sorry. That was brutal. That was.
I proceed to go into my bag. I'm going like maybe shoulder deep. I pulled a little maybe like pebble that's like just pretty smooth.
Mm-hmm.
I'll slide it over to you. No, hey, why don't you touch that for a second?
What is it? You gotta explain it to me before I.
It's a rock. I just want you to pick it up.
What does it do?
You'll see.
No. I have gone through many situations like this where I've been fucked over. You're gonna tell me what it does.
Ah, fine. Okay. I'll put it into my palm, and I will. Then proceed to just put my thumb on the center bit of it, and you hear a very quick 6-second monologue of Edwin talking about how he made this work, like spell wise, as an artificer.
Is that it? What
do you mean that's it? What do you mean? I've been working literally like at least 5 months on this. This is pretty good.
kind of, what does it do? It just tells you it, something?
I proceed to press it again, it does the same thing over again for 6 seconds. Isn't it amazing?
That's really cool, buddy. That's
this
really
is called
cool.
progress.
Yeah, yeah, it's great, bud. You should go show that around. I'm gonna go.
Oh no! Thanks. If I do that, someone's gonna be like, "That's pretty cool," and then they're gonna copy my work. I can't do that. Into the bag it goes.
Okay,
and
cool.
Just open right. the bag and just drop it.
Hey, Asp, can you watch this kid for a sec? I'm gonna go.
A kid?
Yeah. Yeah.
Pretty old. Not really, but
I mean,
the average life of a human, I don't know, is like 42 maybe. I'm like
the average life or average age.
I said average life. And Van was 42. Sure. I'm like, what? Like, I'm in my late 20s. I don't know. I've been really keeping track as of late, but I'm roughly probably around there.
Yeah.
I got to count.
All right, bud. Cool. Very nice. You can either stick with me and, you know, keep your mouth shut while I look for this Booker fellow, or you can go hang out with Asp, or even go check out whatever the hell Fog Blaster is doing. So, you got a couple of options.
I'll stay here.
Okay, cool. I'll see you in a bit. I pat him on the shoulder and I walk away.
Krantz is doing some kind of show for a lot of people. You see him kind of jumping around, dipping in to sign something.
Ah, look at him go!
He doesn't throw any babies, but like he looks like he kind of wants to.
Yeah, there aren't any babies in here. This you're like at a bar, a hotel bar. There are no babies here.
There's definitely like a football or like
he definitely has like a kobold lizard-like desire to throw a baby deep within his little brain. Oh, there, his brain is about the size of a walnut, by the way.
Love that.
Awesome. Even smaller than that, if with that 7 intelligence.
I'm gonna look for
7 intelligence
like
and walnut-sized brain are pretty much the same.
I'm gonna go over to the barkeep real quick, and I'm just gonna be like, "Hey, I got a quick question for you."
Yes. Well, the drinks are not up for negotiation on price.
Yeah, no, I'm not. Then that's fine. I understand that.
Very well. Would you like to get yourself a beverage? Courtesy of the meats well done. Give it a rest.
Yeah, sure. I'm looking for Booker, if you know where he might be.
What kind of drink would you like?
Okay. Can I just have whiskey, please?
Yes, of course. He goes, grabs a whiskey from this crystalline chalice and pours it. I'll be 5 gold pieces, please.
Okay. I give him 5 gold pieces.
He takes it. He's like, well, the whiskey was 5 gold pieces, but information, on the other hand.
I put down I put in my hand, like, a gold piece, and then behind the gold piece is a platinum piece, and I push them together.
He holds his hand out.
I just push it across the table.
All right.
Yeah.
He grabs it. What was it that you said you were looking for?
I'm looking for Booker.
Right next to you.
Fucking A. Okay, thank you. I turn next to me. Is it Booker? Please tell me it's Booker.
No, it's Krant. No. Okay, so the man sitting next to you, the first thing you notice is the smell. It's this mixture of expensive tobacco and old leather. The man himself is a sight to behold. He wears a white collared shirt with the first 3 buttons undone.
He got his chest out.
Yeah. On his head, he wears a flat, wide-brimmed workman's hat of tanned hide. Strands of greasy black hair tangle down from its brim. His neglectfully shaven face... Or his neglectfully shaven facial hair rests around his mouth, which seems to be trapped in a permanent smirk.
So it's Spencer Catlin.
You looking for me?
God damn it. Yes, sir.
Oh, you put it in player zone, Clark.
Oh, god damn it, my bad. Oh, I put Ferris in player zone too. Oops, I'll fix that. Go ahead, we can roleplay. I can do both.
That's the picture of Ferris? Oh my god.
Well, yeah, okay. He's awesome.
He's fucking... No, the picture's just funny.
Here's a picture of that, and then, let me get rid of Ferris.
You looking for me?
Yes, indeed I am.
And why is that?
I believe
that I kill someone you love, too?
No, no.
Yeah, I'm kidding. Well.
Ha. Yeah.
Kind of.
Cool. So I have a couple of questions for you. You were working with Meat Well Done, yeah?
Papers.
Yeah.
You have papers?
I do have papers. What do you want to see them? Okay.
He takes it. What do you give him?
I just give him like the sheet that I was given to, like, come here with, or not, like, the whatever.
Mm-hmm.
The other records I got from Ferris.
Oh, okay, so you're giving him, like, the thing that you got from in your satchel from Broston.
Just, like, the top sheet or something like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
He takes it, he looks over it for a moment, he takes out his cigarette, and he starts to light it on fire, the little corner. All right. Everything's up to snuff.
Pat it down. I go, dude, come on.
What? Here,
I thought you were burning the paper.
I was burning the paper.
Don't burn the paper. Ferris seems to fucking want to have these. Come on, man. I'm trying to get in out here as fast as possible.
Yeah, that tightly wound little elf.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely got something up his ass, but I don't blame him.
Yeah, all I right. guess so. Well, you're here for your Yunling then. Murderer.
Yeah. Yunling, yeah. And whoever the fuck killed him.
Yeah, well. That is true. The, yeah. What was his name again? No. One of the guy who's sitting next to him, like, looks over to him. Jesus fuck. Sorry, a car just drove past my house beeping. It's 10 fucking night. Alright, so, a guy next to Booker looks over to him drunkenly.
His name is Landon Talish, and I know that, but he's always the one who got the information for you, and you fucking took it from me.
Booker grabs a bottle and crashes it across, the other guy said.
You're gonna let me steal it then? Yeah. Talish.
Landon. Yeah. Cool. Any other... What was he like before, I guess, the murder?
Talish or the deceased? Or I guess no, the deceased the, and the soon-to-be deceased.
The soon-to-be deceased.
He was a company man, not in the sport type, but you know he was an admin. I don't exactly know what it was that he did. He probably does, and he gestures over to the guy who's near unconscious on the floor, blood dripping from the back of his head from a broken bottle. Admin type, you know. Motive wasn't exactly there, but he had the opportunity. He was there, and he was digging too. He was digging around into the murder, into that. And first investigation, that's a guilty guy right there.
What do you mean he was digging around into the murder?
Well, you know, murder happens. Next thing you know, we got this investigation going on. None of the mercs, none of us, are brought into it. And apparently, Talish is helping with the investigation. Suddenly, no results. Nothing.
A ghost cured him. Killed him. Next thing you know, Talish up and leaves town.
Where the hell did he go?
Abandoned fort. Real old. Falling apart. Maybe a couple hours south of here.
Okay. Yeah. And this is, I just want to be clear. Talish, and then there's Parish? Palin?
So there's Talish? I'll Talish. Put this in the DM zone. So, yes. We have, you know, it's a lot of names. The names, the two important names here are, like, the two new names.
I know the doctor's name.
Doctor is Johan Yunling.
Yeah, I know that.
Doctor, deceased. And the other is Langdon Talish. Murderer.
Okay. So Talish was digging into the murder, and then poof, he's gone, right?
Yep.
Well, I received info that you found the murderer. Is that he believed to be the murderer?
Yeah. Does it matter?
Yes.
Well, then, yeah, sure. He's the murderer. I believe it. Looking into the case. Gippstown.
Well, if he skipped town because he just didn't want to get caught up in whatever the fuck the murderer, actual murderer, did, you know?
Yeah. Innocent people don't exactly run off to old fortresses, nor do they hire mercenaries to keep them safe. You feel me?
Yeah. Yeah, I feel you.
Yeah.
That's an inside thought. So what's this guy's? Hold on, I'm gonna lean down, like get off whatever bar stool I'm sitting on, and like throw back the whiskey, and then go cast healing word on this, or not healing word. I'll just do cure wounds on the dude that's lying on the floor bleeding.
Mm-hmm. I don't need to do that. He'll be fine.
You know, concussions can be really dangerous, especially in this line of business.
Yeah, I guess so. What are the rest of you doing while this is happening?
I'm like signing things.
I'm talking to the bartender about mixology.
I am observing a weed that has grown out of a split board.
Gotcha.
Fantastic. So what leads do we have outside of fucking Talish?
Leads?
Anything besides the fact leads? That he's just...
There are no leads. He is the lead. We know where he's at. We know he's guilty. We go. He takes his thumb and draws it across the bottom of his throat. Easy as that. We're in. We're out. We get paid. A lot.
Yeah, we get paid a lot, but I still don't understand why the fuck he would kill Yunling. It doesn't make any sense.
Well, I'm not an investigator.
Fair enough.
You want to go?
You know anybody?
You want to go running around asking questions, tracking down leads? You go right ahead. But come morning, we're leaving this place.
Yeah, understand.
We're
going to
be coming back here with the head of Talish.
Alright, how many mercs does he have, or that you guys are aware of?
Well, not exactly a question for me. That, might be a question for him over there. And at this point, the guy who you have cast Cure Wounds on is sort of, like, sitting up, rubbing the back of his head.
You okay there, bud?
Oh, yeah, I'm alright. Thank all right, you for that.
Yeah,
piece of shit. Oh, fuck off.
Alright, so what's the deal with tomorrow? What's going on? How many are we How many mercenaries are we looking at around the building? What's the plan of attack here?
Oh, well, the fuck will I tell you?
Because I am the other hired merc to help you.
Oh. Booker, am I on this job now, all of a sudden? You most certainly are not. That is what I thought. He stands up, he takes a drink, and he shuffles further down the bar. Nope. Mm-mm.
Oh, come on, why not?
Why not? What exactly does it give to me? It's not my job. Not anymore.
Do you want it to be your job?
Well, yeah. You took my information.
Well, if you have more information, you could just give it in.
And what would I get out of that?
The significance of being able to provide more information over Booker.
Too late. You already brought it to that damn elf. Contracts with him.
What if I brought it to the elf and brought you with me?
I'm, not exactly on the best terms with the elf. May have gone to his house. And, you know, he's just said some things.
I see. But, you know, the more information I can get out of this, the more, you know.
Well, how about you make it worth my while?
What do you want?
What do you think I want? He goes and he gestures towards himself.
Fucking another drink. Do you want yourself to be recognized?
Well, you do your drinks tonight. I'm calling it. Fuck off.
Oh, come on, dude.
Starts to walk away a little bit.
I will follow.
What is your fucking problem?
Well, someone might call me persistent, if anything. Look, Booker's a distance away. He's not hearing jack shit. He's not going to rat to anybody and take all the fame.
Fucking pay me.
Put you in a back room. Yeah, what do you want?
50 platinum.
I don't have 50 platinum.
Starts to turn, starts to walk away a little bit.
What are you going to do? You want the information or not?
I do want the information, but look at me. Do I look like I have 50 platinum?
Looks at you, wearing like your glamored armor, which even though it, you know, it still looks like you're normal clothes.
I should look like shit because I was just fucking like fighting in whatchamacallit.
I mean, you would look like shit. The armor would not. Okay, the armor would look pristine.
What if I. Okay, this was a gift from my fucking spouse that I would rather not talk about it.
Right. Well, do you have anything you're actually willing to give up? Anything valuable that I could actually use to put food in my mouth and liquor in my stomach? Then perhaps we can talk. But until then, I bid you adieu.
I have a blur cloak.
What's that?
I don't know. If you want to sneak around, act all fishy.
Let me see that.
I just hold it up. I pull it out of my bag.
He grabs it and looks over it.
This is something.
It's something. That's for damn sure.
Give it to me.
Nope. You have to give me the info first. It's an even exchange.
No. Well, the second I'll tell you this information, you're going to be pissing off and running away.
No, I swear.
Well, we need a mediator. Anybody here? A mediator.
Me. I am.
Eddie.
Am I mediator?
Mike.
No.
Mike. Sorry.
All right.
You give this, give this one the cloak.
Yeah, here. Can you, kid, can you hold this? Just stay put. Stay right there, please.
Yeah.
And just hold this.
Sure, no problem. As they're as it's put in my hands, I'm casting Identify on it.
Okay. Right. Well, these ain't normal mercs that this one Talish hired. No, these ones are for far, far away, south, deep in the mountains. These things, the beast tamers. They're not just normal beasts. It's no bears or tigers. No. These things, the things that they tame are old. Very old.
What do you mean? They know they're experienced as
well? Oh, no. Well, I figure they're experienced, lest they be eaten by them. But these things that they have, they're giant, lizard-like.
Oh, shit.
It's, truly frightening. I've seen that when I was walking by. I saw one of them. It was that big as several oxes. This big armored plate around its neck. Three horns sticking out the front.
Can I roll a history check on this?
Yeah, I think I know.
This wouldn't be a history. This would be a nature check.
Can I do a nature check?
Yeah, I'm gonna try as well. How's a 28 sound?
All right.
Sorry, I'm just getting my sheet back out. It's hidden behind my notes page. That is a 17.
All right. You would both recognize that what he seems to be describing is a dinosaur.
What the fuck? They exist here?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're in the monster manual. It's pretty funny.
That's fucking hysterical. Wait, what?
Does it walk on two or four legs? I'm curious.
Yeah, this one's on four legs, size of an ox.
Ah, I think I know what you're talking about.
So it's several oxes. That's really all I saw. I've heard of this group. They train them. They learn how to control them. They don't come cheap either.
Yeah, no.
I don't know how that little shite managed to pay them off, but. Ooh.
Do you have any idea of where, like how big this shack is, how surrounded we're talking? What are the odds of us getting in?
I mean, it's an old abandoned fortress. It's mostly rubble. The walls don't exactly work on all sides. There should be interesting infiltration. You know, it's an old fortress, fell apart in some war ages ago.
Interesting. Alright. Anything else you could give me information-wise?
That's all I got for you. That's all I know. Give me the cloak.
That's all you know. Yeah, you can have the cloak.
Has a minute passed, so I could cast my identify?
Yeah.
What do I learn about this thing?
It's a blur cloak.
It's the
item that you got, like, back at the start of the campaign.
I do remember it. With my knowledge of, like, magical items and just material in general, what could I say is roughly the gold estimate value on this?
Well, I mean, that just, it depends on the seller. Like, that's the very difficult question to ask.
Material-wise, what is this like?
Material-wise, I mean, it's a cloak. It's just a normal, like, piece of fabric. The effect itself is the kicker.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay. I think I lean over and I grab it to him and say, I think you got a good deal on this. This is quality.
Can I?
Quality work.
Yeah.
Whoever worked on it did a good job.
Yeah, sure.
a gift of an old friend of mine.
I'll treat it well.
Please do. Thank you. I appreciate you.
All right, welcome. Well, I do best be off. Many things to take a look at. And tell Booker he can go fuck himself.
Sure.
All right.
I'm going to make my... I'll write down the notes I have in the little notepad that I have.
All right.
And I'm going to go tuck myself into a bathroom really quick.
All right. So, the rest of you.
I just wanted to ask. Yeah, can I make my glamour armor look, like, dingy? Shit. Can I have it change to look dingy?
Okay, sure.
Just a little.
Yeah, you can do that.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll just do that.
Gotcha. All right. The rest of you. Is there anything in particular you would like to be doing during this time? It seems that for you, Krantz, it seems that your appearance has done a very good job. Everyone is very aware and happy that you are there. You were all given a couple free drinks that what you would do with is entirely up to you. And for us, Krantz was given drinks.
Yeah.
Go on.
I'm gonna walk over to Ask Clark. I'm gonna find him.
Yeah, no one has really been like, no one has like taken specific notice of you since you're.
I have
like
strategically placed seeds in every single cracked board.
All right, sick. All right, make me a perception. Actually, I guess this, yeah, perception check.
All right, hold on. Uh, 11. What's perception? Wisdom?
Yep.
14.
14? Okay. You are very confident. You are pretty confident that you have placed seeds in every single one of these.
Pretty confident. Gonna be a lot of flora in here.
I'll be sitting next to Gus, and I'm have a little screwdriver.
Ooh, not
and
Gus.
Not Gus.
I'm not Gus. Who's Gus?
I'm sitting next to Aston. With a little screwdriver, and I'm tweaking my bird.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, fantastic bird you have there.
Oh, yes. This is Reginald.
Oh, it's not of nature. It seems to be mechanical.
No, it's like I lift one of its wings up, and it has a bunch of, like, little moving gears and stuff, and you see, like, a shiny, like, little blue thing inside the center.
Ah, like a clock.
Exactly. I saw a clock and I was like, I could make this a bird.
Now I ask you, does it have a soul?
No, not the soul.
Not really. No, it's more or less the core thing in the bird. Like, listens to me. It's kind of like its soul. It's like an artificial soul, if you want to put it into that kind of way.
Very nice. Very nice.
Hey, Az. Hey, bud.
Yeah.
What's up? What are you, what's going on?
Oh, I'm just hanging around, you know. I'm trying to spread the word. I'm just do good acts. And, you know, it's been a while since I've been in Holbeck. I used to spend a lot of time here. You know, agriculture and science often co-intersect. And, you know, I'd advise here sometimes. Just wanted to come back to see some of the sights.
I have something that I might need your help with if you're interested, if you want to talk. And I can maybe fill you in on all the gaps that you've missed out on.
Oh, what is it?
Oh, well, let's sit and grab a drink.
Okay.
I guess, kid, you can come along, but it's.
I'm literally in my mid-20s. Late 20s.
Yeah. All right.
You call me kid. How old are you?
I don't know, like 28.
We're 26. Literally the same age. Like, yeah, we're not literally, but.
I just give him a death, like, not a death stare, but I'm just like, I'm giving him a blank stare, like, Like, okay. All right. Come on. Let's just go take a seat. All right. So, you want the good news first or the bad news?
I'll take the bad news.
Okay, so well, there's a list. Let's see. So we got do you remember that we were supposed to go get water for Dry Gully, right? That whole shabam and am.
I wasn't here when last left us.
Oh yeah, so well, yeah, you left on your way.
You left right before that.
So you knew you knew the job was happening, but you left before you went to Dunwich. The party.
Oh, okay. So then I respond, yeah, I remember that. Hello?
Yeah, so there was that. And, you know, we had some issues. I, you know, lost a finger. I owe meat's well done. We were making our way back to Dry Gully when, you know, long story short, we got trapped in the Underdark. Van is, oh, you didn't meet Van. Did you meet Van? I think you met Van, right? On the way back from Ilum?
He knows who Van is.
He knows Van.
I don't know who Van
Yeah,
is.
You know Van. Yeah, you only met him briefly. I don't know where Van is. I know that Bones is still trapped in the, Underdark. Everything sort of looks bleak, and I have, crippling anxiety taking over me, but that's really it. Now here you are. That's the good news. Is we've reunited. That's great. That's fantastic. You found your faith.
So you lost them. And again, they're lost.
Yeah. Yep.
Is this a place we can go back to try to find them?
Back to the Underdark. Let's go.
I don't know. I have a, well, can I show him the arm marking?
What,
like, is that something I can, like, show to people? Like, my fucking tattoo of spousery?
Yeah.
My marriage tattoo, yeah.
You can show that. It is very faint. Like, most people who are just looking won't be able to, like, see it, but if you, like, point it out, you'll be able to be like, yeah.
Should I roll for knowledge of Underdark? Real quick.
What are you attempting to know?
If I know what it is and what's down there.
Sure.
Potentially. Amazing. Is that history?
Yeah.
Okay. 24.
Yeah, no, I mean, you know of the Underdark. You know it is a realm beneath the surface that is filled with dark, horrible creatures you have read about in a book. You don't know any real specifics, you just know that it is a kind of fucked up place that you don't really want to be.
Okay, that's it.
Do I know anything about the Underdark?
I don't know. I don't know how much reason you would have to. You're gonna make an intelligence check.
I mean, I'm an ecologist. Did I learn about the ecology of Underdarkness?
I mean, you probably learned that it's mostly mushrooms and like moss.
What check is this? What check?
And you can make a history check if you want to know like more about like.
Could be nature or history.
Or you can do nature for the ecology. Okay, what check is it? History or nature?
History.
Okay. Again, similarly, you know that the Underdark is a land beneath the surface, and there's a bunch of fucked up stuff down there, and all you have heard is bad stories about, like, crazy shit going on down there.
So it is true what they've said.
Yeah, it's a lot of there's a lot of politics stuff that I didn't really necessarily want to get involved in and got involved in and fucked up a lot. I got married on accident.
Congratulations.
But thank you, but no. Yeah, and I have to somehow break this vow or of sorts, because if I don't and I go back to get Bones out, because he is kind of I don't want to say a shit show, but he's not looking great, I will be stuck down there tied to a blacksmith who will probably masterly manipulate me forever. Despite the fact that, you know, we went on one solid date that I ended up causing a lot more shit
I like
for.
How him guy is categorizing master manipulation as him guy committed a crime and then
stupid.
Got married.
A hate crime, yeah. Might I add?
Yeah.
Yeah, I hate crime. Yeah, yeah. He's gonna pay it all on the woman. Yeah. But anyways, yeah, so that's great.
You don't
great.
Have to be a master manipulator to manipulate him guy.
Him guy? No, you do
be
not.
Be the cute blacksmith.
You just gotta be a cute blacksmith. That's all. Actually, no, he's a little skeptical now. It's changed him. It's definitely changed him. This marriage has changed him.
For the better.
I don't know, man. Yeah. So I, in all of this, I have a favor to ask. I kind of, sort of, was supposed to work on a merc job with Bones or with somebody, you know. Hopefully with the team, but I it's just me and I need help, and I understand you found your faith and you want to go do good deeds, so it's understandable if you don't, but I could really use a solid favor.
Well, it doesn't sound too bad. I'll join along. I can spread the word while doing this. It's not mutually exclusive.
Okay, that's I mean, that's great. It's the old team getting back together again.
We're gonna need
on
more
me.
Men.
Well, we're working with meets well done.
I'm a man.
You, yeah.
Oh come
meets
on!
Well
what's
done.
What's the
what a fantastic
harm.
Corporation. I'd be honored.
What's the harm of me helping? Come on, look at me. I can help you guys.
I am looking at you, and I have been looking at you since you first were thrown into the office, scrawled on the forehead, and then knocked twice in the face. So, you know, like, call me what you will, but I will call myself a skeptic of yourself.
You're
what are we
talk.
All doing here? Krantz is going to walk over.
Crowd behind you.
Krantz walks between someone's legs into the middle of the group.
Hey, buddy. What's up? How are you doing? How's
you
that?
Got like a, you got a quest or something?
You could call it a quest.
I kind of got to get out of town. City Air doesn't really agree with me.
What,
besides, it'll be
what?
Good publicity.
I would definitely talk to the, you know, elf about that.
You might want to talk to your sponsor.
Oh, don't worry about it. Oh, it'll be fine.
You might be right, breaking contract.
Yeah, maybe let's go talk about it outside. Let's go. Come on.
What's the contract?
It's a.
God fucking damn it.
Do you do you mind?
All right, Eddie. All right. Take your fucking inspiration.
Let go.
Oh my God.
Do you have any forms of documentation when
well, that
you were
was good.
Hired?
He set it up before with a who wants to get my signed contract.
Yeah.
It's set up. That's like a 3-hour callback.
I'm glad.
You know, like the thing, you know, like the contracts you were like selling to people? Yeah, can I have a copy?
Oh, yeah, sure. I'll hand it over.
All right, I'm going to read this contract real quick.
Mm-hmm. What are you looking for?
Any discrepancies that look like that could be harmful to the individual without his knowledge, seeing how how weak-minded he is.
I mean, it's a pretty standard sports contract. You know, your, like, life and existence is owed to the team and the
corporate sponsors, et cetera, which supply the team, that being Meets Well Done. The termination of the contract may happen at any time, given the sponsor's decision, be it trade or be it simply termination, et cetera, et cetera. Any sort of permanent bodily injury is also proper grounds for end of statement, et cetera, et cetera. It seems like a pretty standard contract for what you would expect an athlete is, like, responsible for, which is you show up to shit, you play good, and you don't hurt yourself outside of the game.
All right, do you mind if I keep this?
Oh, yeah, sure, I'll reach out and sign it.
Oh, okay. I'll fold it, put it in my coat pocket. If someone tries to do something with, like, involving you as a individual for this company, I'll represent you so you make sure this goes down easy, okay?
Hmm. You know, I think I'm good with the representation I have here, but I'll take it into consideration.
Okay.
Not really type for an agent, you know, more of a free spirit.
Oh, that's 100%. It's just that I would just be doing all the paperwork, so you understand I can then tell you what to do.
Mm.
Well, no, you're free form. I don't have to tell you to do anything. I just have to read the paperwork.
Mm.
I'm doing it for free.
Let's get out of town. Let's go do some stuff.
Okay.
All right, as long as you just don't hurt yourself, we're fine.
You wish to leave the hero's rest?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. So you all exit out of there, and you start to make your way into Holbeck. Him guy, you feel a tug on your leg. Look down to see a young girl reaching up, sort of grabbing onto the side of your leg. Pardon me, sir. Could I speak to you for a moment?
What's up, kid?
Can we squire away for a moment?
Oh, it's the squire. It's the.
No, you can talk to me right here, bud.
No. I think it would be best if we didn't do this where there were prying ears.
No.
Fine. You're going
either
after...
walk and talk.
Fine. You're going after Yenling's killer.
That's. Wait, why do you know that?
Duh.
Seems suspicious to me.
The mercenaries? All they talk about.
Yeah, I figured. Small town. Whatever. Alright, kid, what's up?
And Booker. He's going with you.
Well, I'm going with him, I guess.
Okay.
Why, you got some insights on him?
Can I come along?
Why do you want to come along?
God, it's another, what's his name?
It's another fucking Briler situation.
So, you look down and you see this very determined young girl. She's wearing this odd assortment of light armor topped off with a long purple scarf. Her eyes show this unbreakable resolve. Well, first off, hello. My name is Rini Yellowfield. I want to be an adventurer, and I want to be a knight, and I would like to go with you, please.
Well, okay. Well, slow it down there, bud. You have any experience?
Yeah, a lot, actually. I have a sword. Here's an art for you.
Oh, cute.
Yeah, and I'm good with it too, and I won't get in your way, and I'll go and I'll help where I can, and I won't get hurt, and I can make my own meals, and I'm very resilient. That's what my mom says.
Your mom? Well, all right. That's very cool, Rini. How old are you?
I don't think that's important.
Well, I just want to know. I just want to make sure we're all on the same page here. For instance, my name is Him Guy. I'm going to put my hand out to her.
Yes, sir, it is nice to meet you. Can I come with you?
So when we're having these conversations, you're gonna have to, you know, walk through the steps. You know, you're very resilient, I can see that. But, you gotta, you know, really tell me why. You know what, kid? How do you know about this? Why do you want to go so bad?
The mercs were talking about it, and I want to be a hero and a knight and stuff.
Why are you in such a rush?
And well, I need to go now. I need to go on this.
Rini, you're gonna have to sit down and tell me why. Why do you need to go on this big adventure so fast?
Make me a persuasion check, please.
Okay. Let's see here. That is a 19 plus 14. So,
33.
Yeah.
All right. She sighs. She's like, okay, fine. What can you... She goes and she grabs onto your arm and starts to, like, try and drag you towards a... Like, drag you away from, like, the sort of main square, just off to the side a little.
Okay, I will just, like, lean down so she can, like, whisper in my ear or some shit.
It's Booker. Alright? It's Booker.
What do you mean, it's Booker?
It's Booker. It's why I need to go on this. Booker is a ruthless fucking merc. He's one of the corporation's favorites. My family lost a steer and couldn't make our payments to the town, so they sent Booker. He killed my father without giving him a chance to explain. He didn't even ask him anything. He just walked up to our farm and just started slashing towards my dad. He broke my dad's sword and he stabbed him in the neck with it. I need you to kill him.
Oh, that was a horrible time for my headphones to die. But I,
God fucking damn it.
Well, no, they died right after you said he needs to die or something like that.
Put Rini Yellowfield in player zone.
God, did I? Fuck. Shit, alright.
They have a second Vanessa type character.
I'll fix this. Don't worry, guys, I'll fix this.
I thought for a second it was gonna be Vanessa. I'm like, how the fuck did you get here?
I've gotta have, like, a league of orphaned sword-fighting women.
The NPC repository.
You also need to put Roy Slade in Edwin's... Or not Edwin, but Roy Slade.
Is Roy Slade in the other one? God fucking damn it. Alright. Fucking, I'll fix it. Shut up. Alright. So, Rini has now just asked you to kill Booker.
Can we call it a cliffhanger? Because I don't know how to answer this.
Yeah, honestly, we are right near the end, and I think that is a good place to stop for the time being, then.
I need you to kill my dad. My Booker. He killed my dad.
Booker's your dad.
He killed my dad.
Booker's him guy's dad? Oh my god. See, now that's a cliffhanger.
That would be a twist. Yeah.
And with that, we shall call this session as we have begun again. Thus,
season two,
we got renewed.
Podcast
out. Clark, I want to watch the
podcast
intro.
Out.
I want to see the shit I missed.